Oh boy. Oh, it's time to pray for Jimmy. Big boy trouble's coming my way. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to this lovely Saturday stream. If you had tuned in 4 days ago, you'd see that I was absolutely correct. I was discussing a little bit of drama that happened with a YouTuber by the name of Drummer. Drummer had a video he uploaded 10 years ago. Sat on his account for 10 years, idling. Completely forgotten. Nobody really cared about it. Except for a YouTuber by the name of Montagraph, who decided to start sending threatening emails to Drummer and doing spooky online shit because Drummer wasn't bending over and taking it up his ass. Well, I watched this play out for about 30 days, laughing as it happened, and I made a statement. I said that Montagraph has plenty of evidence out there of doing a lot of underhanded things. Doxing people, swatting people, flagging people, getting them fired from their jobs and suing them. And what do you know? Now he has me on his list. I'm on his list with a lot of people. Lots of people are on that list, and Jimmy just got added to it. I'm right up there with Drummer, of course, Liquid Monty, Jake Morphonius, sorry about that, Google, PayPal, Twitter, 7 unidentified sweaty men. We'll get to all of this very soon. But I pushed it too far. Wasn't the furries, was it the diaper-shitting autists on the internet who like the crap in a Pampers? It was motherfucking Montagraph that's going to teach me a big boy lesson. So we're going to be going over a legal case he recently filed against somebody for laughing at him, because he hates to be laughed at. And we're going to see how that went out. And we've got a special guest, Nick Rekieta, is going to be joining us to discuss the court case itself and to, well, I don't want to spoil it just yet, but let's say Nick's on that list too. Nick made the mistake of tweeting out nothing, essentially laughing about the situation, just like I had in regards to Drummer. And what do you know? Nick got put on the big boy list of getting butt-fucked later on down the line. Oh, it's Trouble Town. The train is headed straight to Trouble Town, and I'm in the caboose with Nick and everybody else. So let me get the Google Hangout set up. Let me invite Nick on. We've got a lot of fun stuff planned. We're going to look at the court case. We're going to look at some videos, some statements that have been put up by our boy, Mr. Montagraph, Mr. Monty, of some of the threats that he's made. Maybe you don't know this, but he has magical psychic powers, and I'm going to die. He's informed me that I'm a dead man. Within 30 days, I'm going to be driven off the road. That's what he's told me. We'll take a look at that. I don't know what's going to happen first. What bad, unfortunate thing. Am I going to get sued first, or am I going to be driven off the road, Monty? Which one's going to happen? I really do enjoy watching you try to make threats and have to be subtle about it, because you know if you outright stated you're going to drive me off the road, you'd be locked up in a loony bin. But let me get this set up. Let me get this set up here. Oh, no, I don't need to do that. Make sure I've got the proper stuff. Oh, God. There we go. And we'll get Nick in here, and we'll have Nick join us. Oh, fun times ahead. Let me just send him the link here. Hopefully he's eagerly awaiting our discussion with Mr. Monty. Yeah, lots of super chats. I see that you all remember the formula here on what happens when unfortunate things occur. Pay me. I'm very sad. You need to fucking pay me. All right, this happened when I got doxxed. I was very fucked up about it. That KickFundMe got me through those tough times. Lawsuit's coming. Very sad. Lots of tears falling down my fucking cheeks. Let me just shout one out here for the absurd amount of money it is from Sword and Scales. Jimbo being sued, here's a little something for your legal defense fund and for that paint thinner you drink. Well, I do love my Kharkov. There's nothing better than horrific tasting fucking vodka. If you're not shitting blood, you're not drinking real man's liquor. All right, get that gin and rum crap the fuck out of here. You need something amazing. Okay, let me send the link here. If Nick is listening, it should be sent to you. And then I'll check audio levels to make sure I'm not a complete inept retard. And then I think we're good to go. We'll find out real quick. Hello.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Okay, let me just adjust the audio just a tiny bit. Do you want to say something? Did you choose to go silent for that?
No.
Oh, there
can
we go.
You, or am I here? Am I here, Jim?
Yep, you're here. You're here. I know a lot of people usually throw Google Hangouts up on the screen. Instead, I have it in the background. So nobody's going to know you're naked right now.
Oh.
It's our fucking secret.
Thank God. Thank God. But you can enjoy that. You can enjoy the nudity.
I love
that.
I love male nudity. I would expect nothing less from the leader of the legal team for the sweaty sausage squad, Nick.
I've been eating sweaty sausage.
Have you? Is
for
it delicious?
So long.
Oh, it's good.
The extra salt on it makes it perfect.
I'd be careful. You don't want to moan too loudly. Montagraph might get the wrong impression. He really likes that those toe-sucking pictures he's been putting up on his Twitter. I don't know if you've seen those.
I have. Let me just suggest, I am not a melon. And
you're not going to be fucked?
I will not. I will not.
Well, let me just state this clearly to keep you out of any snafus going forward. You're simply a guest. You're not legal counsel. I haven't paid you for your services. You're just a guy coming on to talk about some crazy shit.
Well, and hopefully laugh a lot at a very, very exceptional individual.
Yeah. Now, I sent you a couple things, actually. I sent you a clip, a compilation clip. Did that pop up for you?
Yep. I haven't watched through all of it.
Oh, no,
I have a guest here, but I was watching through, and it's great.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure the audience is going to like that, as well as the write-up by I got to keep saying Jake. I think it's Jack or Jake, Morphonius from
yeah.
Blackstone Intel. Now, he has a whole thing. We'll read through that. I'll show that to the audience and stuff, too, about his legal case with Montagraph. And the weird thing about that, too, is I'm fairly certain these are the court documents. Now, I know Josh from Kiwi Farms did a phone call with Montagraph earlier today, and Montagraph said, well, you know, the real filing's 23 pages long, which, you know, I checked, what do you know, 23 pages. So I think everything Jake has put up on his website is legit, at least from my point of view. I don't know. Hopefully you can answer. I've got lots of interesting questions when it comes to this kind of stuff. Hopefully you can answer some fun questions. And why don't we start... You know what? Let me do this. Now, I sent you, the way I set it up is I sent you an unlisted video so you can watch the clips, and then I've got the video on my desktop so I can show it to the audience.
Perfect.
And that way we can pause and kind of talk as it goes through. Because I think they need to really see what we're talking about, what we're dealing with here. Because, you know, I'm just going to say outright, this dude comes off as pretty unhinged. Now, he did a couple of things, God, even before this stream started. But I just want to show everybody kind of what we're talking about. Over the last day, on his YouTube page, yeah, it was in the last 24 hours, he put up four videos talking about how he was going to sue me, how he was going to sue a bunch of other people, how people were going to be getting doxxed, how shit was going to be going down. I believe he even mentioned when he was on stream with Josh that he's flagging my Twitter account and other people's accounts to teach them a lesson. You know, very outright hostile. Now, he deleted all of these, and I'm going to guess he deleted them because he's embarrassed or he's worried about it. Luckily, I've archived fucking everything. you know, and just to kind of show people, I don't know if you have the stream open. I didn't send you these pics, but I can just kind of describe them. This is something common he would put up on his community page. This is Drummer. This is the guy that he was going after. It says, congrats, Drummer 828. You are the 247th person that we have doxxed. Now all of your lies about others will be added. Your first and middle and last name, along with your location. Enjoy your fame. This seems to be a common tactic that he employs. He'll get into arguments with people, find out their, you know, personal information, package it up, and then just make ridiculous threats or outright try to get them fired. I mean, we're going to see that in the clips that we watch. Now, to bring this home, this is what he wrote to you. And again, for people wondering, Nick was just responding to me talking about this guy threatening to sue me, and you laughed about it, essentially, and said, come on my stream if you get sued.
Yeah, you would need to apologize to the earth.
Oh, to everybody. Everybody needs to know.
Of course.
And, you know, under his YouTube handle, or I'm sorry, under the Twitter handle, he's got like 18 different aliases. But under his account, October Rains, he went right at you. And this is what he did to me when I laughed about the drummer thing. I said, Nick, you apparently are not that bright. Free speech is one thing, but criminal harassment and conspiracy is another. So are you condoning such behavior? Not very professional, hotshot. Would you like your name attached to such horrific lies? I eagerly await your answer. Now, you had tweeted out that, like, maybe 5 minutes after he posted this, he called you.
Yeah. Yeah, I was driving my kid around. I get a phone call and it goes to my my law office number. And so I pick it up and sure enough, it's this guy. Hello, I'm Montagraph on Twitter. And I'm like, oh, all right. I have no idea who this person is ever. Never heard of him. And then he said something that I didn't hear. And so I asked him to repeat it. And that's when the whole call got started. Has he posted it yet? He threatened to post my phone call.
He threatened a lot of things. And now I've included, that's the majority of the video we're going to watch. Because I clipped it. There was some stuff that wasn't really important. I tried to keep it everything related to you.
Sure.
But, you know, it's like, we got like 12 minutes of that 26-minute video where he's saying that he's going to basically fuck you into the dirt.
Good.
As well as other clips that I think people are really going to enjoy hearing, just how insane this guy is. Because the stuff that he talks about, he talks about how he taught the CIA a lesson, how he brought down a Rothschild, how he was the guy that destroyed Q and identified him. Just lots of really, really interesting things. And I don't know if you pay attention to his community pages, but he's posted up your information on his YouTube.
Oh, I hope so. What information? My law office information?
He had some stuff up that he deleted. One of the things that's up right now, I don't know if you care or not. It's a law firm stuff. I'm fairly certain right now that's up there.
I don't care. I mean, this guy, I'm almost positive he's not properly doxed me or anything like that. But
he has other things up there too about you.
Oh, sure.
Like the one I have on screen right now. It says, oh, look, I wonder if Mr. Anaboli is going to cover the attorney threatening to dox people.
I remember that tweet. I actually, I believe I got like knocked off of Twitter for a day because of that. And it was a sarcastic response to someone saying I doxed Kevin Landau by listing his P.O. box in New York.
Well, and he's only got like half of it on there, but it looks like you're saying I'm going to dox a butt.
It was a bunch of people.
Oh, there we go.
So the background of this is I did a video when Kevin Landau filed an ethics complaint against me. And so he had his law firm's New York Regis office listed on there. It's like 45 Broadway or something. It doesn't really matter. And I didn't redact the address because it's not a real, you know, it's not a real place where people are. It's just a rent-an office.
Right.
And so then a bunch of people, like a year later, accused me of doxing Kevin Landau. And so this was response to that when I was doing a video. And I said, I'm going to dox a bunch of people, which was a complete joke because I didn't dox anybody.
Well, and I like this screen grab he put up. If you click on it, it doesn't even show the whole thing. Like, he couldn't even get it centered properly. So it just looks like you're talking about doxing people's asses. So that's always a good look. Watch out. You know, he's got you on that one.
I mean, that's my other website.
Oh yeah, you know, yeah. All right, so let me do this real quick. Close the chat window. I'm just gonna run this from my desktop.
And myself.
I don't want that to squeeze through here. Okay, I'm just getting the video lined up. If you wanna just jump on the video itself, you know, I'll get everything kind of set up here to play.
Yeah, once you say play, I'll hit play.
Yeah, and then if you have anything you want to say, just say you know, like pause it or whatever. And,
sure.
We'll go through. The whole thing is like 16 minutes. I'm sure we'll enjoy it. And again, this is a sample of the videos that he put up on. He's got like 20 accounts, and he puts them all up on different accounts. So I've saved them. I've archived them. They're funny to me. I don't know why he takes them down when he makes all these amazing threats to people, but we'll see kind of what this guy is up to. So let me get Windows Capture up here, and I think we'll be good to go. All right. So it should show the chat window and it should show the video. I just want to double check. There's a little bit of stream lag, and then I think we're good.
I hope you're ready, Mr. Mediocre.
Nikki, are you ready to get fucking super sued by Montagraph?
Only if I get sued by Piledriver. That's it. That's the only way. I better go at least a half foot into the dirt.
This guy, I swear to God, is just... it's the kind of gift you rarely get in the world. Okay, looks like it's showing up on screen. I think we're good. We'll start it off. I tried to put it chronologically so people can get an idea of what this guy says. Oh, and there's one video here I should tell you in the audience. I had to mute the audio on it because it was just a copyrighted song, but that's not even the important part. You'll see when we get to there about the you're going to die shit that's coming up. So just on the count of three, sound good to you?
Yep, sounds great.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Myself have gone up against the CIA. You understand me, shithead? And my investigations have flit the eyes of Trey Gowdy in Congress, dummy. When it comes to Benghazi. Matter of fact...
Yeah, let me just pause it at 18 seconds here. Already you know who you're dealing with, right? Trey Gowdy, he's flipped the attention. He's got the attention of Trey Gowdy. And he's been involved with the Benghazi hearings. I don't know if you caught that, but we're fucking with somebody who's... It's a big deal.
I'm terrified. I saw what happened at Benghazi.
Yeah, I know. You know what? I don't want that happening to me. Okay, we'll pick it up again at 18 on 3, 2, 1.
I was in a book by best-selling author by the name of Kenneth Timmerman. Look it up, jerk off. You don't even know who you're playing with.
Don't know who you're fucking with.
You're dealing with an individual that has absolute contacts with mainstream media.
Contacts?
ABC context. Is my family.
Oh, yeah. I'll pause it at 42 seconds. No. He's made this claim numerous times on Twitter and in multiple videos. He talks about the Illuminati and how they're controlling the world, but then he'll threaten you and say, you don't understand. My family's basically mainstream media royalty. They worked at ABC News. They worked at MSNBC. If you fuck with me, I'm going to have you on the front page of papers across the country kind of stuff.
Please don't do that.
I know. Wait till you see what his plan for you is. I think you're I think we'll pick it up again at 42. Let's go.
It stick. Now listen here, dumbass. If you want to be an international superstar, keep running that hole in your face.
You screw around with me on the internet, you're going to be identified. You're going to be located. And if it comes to it, I'm going to take legal action against you. And how would I confirm that? With a summons.
With a summons.
Put me in the courtroom somewhere.
I'll pause it at 107. He makes this, he like alternates, I don't know legal terms, right? So maybe he's correct, but he alternates between saying that he's going to have a sheriff show up at your house with a summons and a subpoena. So can you explain to me and the audience what the fuck is he talking about when he says that's happening?
Well, if you get a summons, it's a notice that you need to appear in court under penalty of contempt. If you get a subpoena, you need to typically produce information to the court. So both of them could be right. Typically, a summons accompanies a complaint or a petition, and a subpoena would be a separate document if you're only getting a subpoena, it'd be because you're a non-party, but you might have information relevant to it. But, he's just going through his glossary of legal terms.
Yeah, he seems to be hitting the bullet points when it comes to legal terms. I didn't have a chance to rip this. Maybe we'll do a follow-up stream someday and talk about it. But his plan was to file a lawsuit. He talked about it for like a month. And his lawsuit was going to be for the total of $1 billion. And
just a billion?
Just a billion solid. Nice, even, round number people can get their heads around. And he was going to sue, I think it was Google or somebody, but $1 billion. He was just going to, and he represents himself, is it pro se when you do yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he's wait till we get to the TJ Maxx shit. You're going to love this. Okay, I'm sorry. Let's look. We'll start over at 107 and go.
Because you decide to do something ridiculous. Agent 19's got a real big surprise for you too. He sure does. So when are you gonna make your
watch him for Agent 19?
Because if you cross that line, I don't know, the police will be at your door knocking on your door. Ding dong, how you doing? Yeah, we got a call. See, are you being naughty?
We got a call.
You better stop being naughty. You're gonna go to court.
I'll pause it at 131. Yeah, he's got like, it's really hard to pin it down. Like I've been trying to think of who he reminds me of. And it's like a weird mixture of like Hank Hill with dentures and Boomhauer from fucking, you know what I'm talking about? Like that's what he sounds like.
Dangle summons in there.
I tell you what, boy, he's got that kind of drawl to him too. Sometimes,
yeah, it's like the guard in Cool Hand Luke or whatever.
Yes, that's perfect. Okay, well we'll start up. Yeah, Agent 19, by the way, is his. A super best friend on the internet who he sends out to do his bidding. Agent 19's gotten kind of quiet. Maybe he's getting ready to super dox us.
How many how many what's Agent 19's body count roster even look like? Can it be listed in one key document?
It's classified, Nick. I don't think you understand. Okay, this guy, he understands OPSEC. We're talking deep state levels of identity obfuscation. I put the word. He wears a ski mask. So when he does videos,
didn't that Dallas shooter wear a ski mask the other day? Wasn't he?
Maybe Agent 19 has been busy. I can't speak to that. Purely speculation on our part, but you never know, right? It's stranger things have happened. But Agent 19, yes, he starts all his videos off by saying, "What does he say?" He says he has like this mantra, like this old retarded mantra. I know who you are, but you don't know who I am, and that's how I like it. Some shit like that in his little ski mask, talking about super doxing 50-year-old women on Facebook. So we'll pick it up again at 1:31.
So let's go ahead and go through the facts. The reason why we come after people, the reason why people lose their jobs, and we're very proud of it too. We're very proud of it when we can help them lose their jobs. We'll tell you why.
Oh, he's the worst person on earth.
Yeah, I'll pause it at 1:45. Yeah, right? Like, he's very open about what he does. He'll try to deny it, but then he'll make videos repeatedly stating it and bragging about it. He's openly said, and, you know, I have it archived and saved, so it's not just my word. He doxes people. He bragged on a guy got a police visit during a stream, and he bragged that that was him, that he was responsible for that. He brags about getting people fired from their jobs. Like, he takes pride in it, of trying to fuck people out of work. He takes pride in flagging people's stuff. He brags about that. He takes pride in saying that he'll sue people. And, you know, I think this is like a new chapter in his crazy autobiography, because with the Jake Morfonius thing, that was just in May, right? So I think he's finally moved into actually doing that.
Oh, that's so good. There's nothing better than when you get to see someone's plans really unfold and they explode like the wonderful autistic butterfly that they are.
Oh, it's always amazing. All right, 1:45 and continue.
We're very proud of contacting law enforcement and trying to potentially stop some lunatic on the internet that is showing signs of, let's say, incompetence or, let's say, instability to protect the public. Mr. Mediocre, when I have his account, his YouTube account, subpoenaed, I'll sue him too.
Oh, let's pause it at that. Now, that's, I think, just not just for me, but I think for anybody watching this, pause it at 2:13. He's going to have my account subpoenaed. So what is the process of subpoenaing a YouTube account? Could you walk people through for watching this?
Sure. You have to send a proper subpoena under the rules of, it should be San Francisco, whatever the local rules in San Francisco are for the federal court there. You would have to send that straight through to YouTube Legal. It would probably take a little while to get, and you typically would have to back up the basis of the subpoena with a legitimate legal action. They're not normally going to just release a bunch of information, but assuming they complied with the subpoena and didn't say, "Oh, I've seen this lunatic before," they would go ahead and release whatever information you used to establish your YouTube account. So,
Shit! So they're gonna find out I'm Matt Jarbo. Oh, God,
yep.
I'm in trouble.
It's about time the world knows.
It's about time these boulders were pushed away and the truth was revealed. Yep.
My favorite part of that was the breakneck head turn on Mr. Mediocre.
Oh, well, we're dealing with a meme master. I mean, we'll get into that. I think he taught us both a lesson on Twitter earlier today with his memery.
I'm working all day, 24/7 ops, to keep my wife off of Twitter so she doesn't see how ashamed I am of the memes.
Well, that egg meme, I mean, that's a kill shot. I don't know how you even made it to this stream, to be honest with you. I mean, that's pretty devastating, let's be honest.
Well, an L is for looser, which I think that's because when I sit down, I now hit the floor. Stools no longer work because of the looseness.
Well, yeah, he opened you up. I mean, I thought that was an illusion, or God, he's already got me talking like him. That he's inside my head, but he is a remote viewer. We'll get to the psychic stuff. Let's pick it back up at 2:13 and go.
And when we identify and you locate you, we're putting you on criminal complaints. Cindy, my jurisdiction's going to do an investigation, and then if they feel if there's any validity to it, they're going to send a packet to your jurisdiction. They're going to pick you up and have you arrested.
Gonna guess you're not ever gonna get a packet.
A little bit.
Yeah, I'll pause it at 233. I mean, this is one thing that interests me about him, and you know, even just him aside, a couple of people, but he's openly stated that he wants to use lawsuits not to win in court. He said this openly, not to win in court. He doesn't care. He just wants to get information to go after you so he can publicly embarrass you. Now, I mean, isn't that like a criteria for vexatious litigation, right? Where they're just using the courts to harass people?
Yes. Although typically with vexatious litigation, you have to file multiple suits against a single person, and there's usually some local rule on what that number is, or you have to do something that the court finds so egregious. And I mean, making videos like this might be one of those things where you say, I'm going to do this just to pester and hinder and cost you time and money. It's not a bright move. But of course, I can assume that this guy is, probably broadcasting from whatever Knights Inn he sucked someone off to borrow their key card at 10:45 a.m. before checkout, so he could slip in there and record a video or two before going back to whatever bridge he lives under.
Oh, Nick, are you remote viewing him? That's his shtick. You're not supposed to use psychic powers to see what he's up to.
No, he is not the only CIA-connected Zen master of all the psyops and the human out there. My spiders are crawling in every web.
Watch out, Montagraph. You're dealing with a psychic level 100 master wizard over here. You've bitten off more than you can chew.
Oh, someone's calling me. But I don't think it's him, because it wasn't a Chicago number. That's too bad.
Oh, yeah, well, he likes to, from what I understand, it could be him. Like, I think he likes calling during streams or after tweets. So maybe we'll find out. I don't know. We'll pick it up again at 233. Go.
Maybe give you a little ticket, tell you to show up in court. You got to pay $500. And then Monty has to pick up the phone and contact ABC News, which we really did. And then ABC News called up YouTube, and YouTube was kissing my ass, and I got all the emails to back it up. But they're like, oh, we're sorry. We're so sorry. Oh, I was next in as AI. Oh, sorry. Tough shit. It's too late. Yeah. And do we need to get the press involved again? I mean, really? Okay.
All right. I was hoping he was going to say president.
Oh, God. Yeah. I'll pause it at 306. Yeah. There's a lot to this. I've got the Morphonia suit we'll look at, but in his video directly addressed to you, he references another lawsuit he filed, and apparently he's stating he went after a lawyer, and he was like, I dare you, Nick. I dare you, Nikki, to read the insummation, Nikki. I dare you to read it and see what I do. You're fucking with the thunder, Nikki. Like, he's so, have you ever seen somebody try too hard to be intimidating and it just goes past intimidation back into humor? That's kind of where he's at. That's a gear he's stuck in.
Yeah, the only intimidation I saw that I was intimidated for that melon. I mean, the look on that melon's sad face. Oh my God!
They don't even know about the melon yet. I mean, some people.
Okay.
Yeah, some people on Twitter understand the melon references, but we'll get to the melon sodomy in a little bit. Okay, we'll pick it back up. 306. Go.
Opportune time. You're proliferating information that is 100% incorrect again. What is wrong with you, bud? This is why a federal lawsuit is going to be filed against Google.
Okay, yeah, we can talk over this. This is the video he put up about this. You should be on the October Rains thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this is the whole video. This is like a minute long segment out of a 6 minute video. This is the whole thing that he sent. Between now and July 25th of 2019, you will personally be involved in a car accident. These are facts, and there is no escape. Laugh all that you want. It is not a joke. And now, he said his super secret powers are what allowed him to see into the future and know that I'm going to die because an RV is going, and there's military footage and missile pictures. I don't know why those are in there. Just so you know, it's serious. Like, hey, look, You got a marching band and a missile. Don't fuck with
and
us.
And I'm gonna make some.
These are all the people involved in that car accident.
Oh yeah, yeah. Well, positive 413. This is the video now. I believe we're on the video that is directly addressed to you.
Oh, thank God.
Yep. So we'll watch through this. It's I took 12 minutes of it. It's like a 26 minute long video. And feel free to answer any of his allegations, any of the things he has to say. I know you're shook.
Right? I have a lot to answer for. Oh, yeah. Man, I can't.
He did call you Nikki, and I mean, that is pretty devastating with the pictures and everything. So we'll start it up at 4:13, and yeah, you got anything to say, just say it, and I'll pause it as we go. All right, ready?
All right. Yep.
All right, let's go.
Memes that is going to dazzle the hell out of you. Sure am, because he's the head counsel. It's going to be a lot of fun. I hope you don't mind laughing at yourself there, Nikki. You don't mind if I call you Nikki?
Nikki.
I don't mind.
I don't mind if you call me Nikki, and I love laughing at myself.
I paused at 4:34. Yeah. You've seen the master of memes. Like, he told you, I'm going to meme the shit out of you, Nikki. And he totally did. He really went to town with Adobe Photoshop to teach you a lesson.
Yeah, I've gotten a collection of them. I think Kiwi Farms compiled them, and one of my my Discord moderator just went ahead and gave me all of the memes. God, they're good. Oh. I love the one where like Teddy Ruxpin is about to rape my egg.
Yeah, you know, really high level, super smart shit, like, you know, 9,000 IQ stuff. That's really hard for us plebs to grasp onto. Okay.
Yeah. I'm ready.
Are you ready for this? Get ready, because he's gonna tell you what's gonna happen. He's got a whole plan laid out for how he's gonna destroy you, bro. And I feel bad for getting you involved in this, but we'll start back up at 4:34 now.
Think that because you're an attorney, I'm supposed to give you or grant you some sort of automatic respect? Wrong. You might want to go ask Mr. Hampton. Out of the state.
No respect.
Michigan. If that, how that worked out for him.
Yeah, I think that's the one.
Why don't you go ask Mr.
Hampton,
former employee that fired him
of Michigan.
Me.
I hate Michigan attorneys. I'm with you.
Company, Jackson National Life Insurance. We dropped
former employee that fired him. That's weird.
Oh yeah, pause at 507. Yeah, it's weird. He says the guy was a lawyer and he went after him, but then he's like he worked at a life insurance company. So I don't know if he was a lawyer for the life insurance company or if he was just like representing himself like pro se and he thinks that means he's a lawyer.
Yeah, it's on the phone call with me, here's the deep lore. He said, you know, your employer that would potentially fire you. And I said, wait, do you think my employer is going to fire me? And he said, well, no, they probably won't. That might be the most correct thing he said. Montagraph, my employer will not fire me. But you can lodge all of the complaints you need to Rekieta Law, my employer. Please just lodge the complaints there, and I'm sure my employer would be happy to address all of them. He's a very patient man, and he's happy to collate all of those complaints and really read me the riot act when it comes down to it. So
well, you're gonna get a scolding. I mean, I'm familiar with your boss and I think it's gonna be a tough time, but maybe you'll survive it. Maybe
he's tough but fair.
Tough but fair. That's true. That's very true. But I mean, not just can I ask you now before we get to it, because did you say something to him specifically? Because he gets real fucking mad later on in this video, and he's like, you know what you said in that video, I'm going to release audio on you.
The only thing I said was that I didn't consent to a recorded phone call, just in case he was in a two-party state and to mess with him. Other than that, I made fun of him a little bit, but nothing crazy. Like, I was just talking to this weirdo who called me up, so who I know nothing about. I didn't even have the ammo to make fun of him other than what he said to me on the call, because I've literally never heard of him before.
Yeah, he got really offended. Just to give a little background to Chad. So he, you know, I'm watching what he's doing with Drummer, right? Which is the YouTuber he went after. And I'm looking into like stuff that he's done. Like, is this just a joke or like what's the story behind it? And I keep seeing all these people talking about how like him and his friend Agent 19 would do super ops on people and just, you know, dox them and do all this other shit. And so I'm looking through YouTube. I'm looking up all these videos And I come across one, which is like a compilation of older YouTube videos. And it talks about him and some like really weird sex shit, right? And I posted on Twitter and I'm like, this rabbit hole is getting really dark. That's not even a declarative statement. I'm not saying anything about him personally. I'm just saying, you know, like this video that I've come across that somebody has uploaded to this website, it's some pretty dark shit in there. And he fucking flipped, right? Like that pissed him off. And I think that he thought, this is what I believe is happening. I think he believes that you are familiar with all of this and that you think it's funny too. And now you're on his shit list, right? Like that's the only conclusion I can come to.
It must be. And the funny thing was I wasn't, but now I am. And it is hilarious. It is absolutely. I hope we get to discussing that wonderful chocolate sorbet or whatever.
Oh, the two girls, one cup thing. We've got a lot of fun stuff planned. I think it'll be enjoyable, but we'll kick it back off at at 5:07 to listen to his master plan. Let's continue.
Guys to come get me until, of course, I release that audio recording of the vice president of security admitting wrongdoing by their junior executive. I know it's horrible, isn't it? So you have involved yourself
it is horrible.
In this, Nikki.
Just terrible.
And now you're going to pay for it.
Nikki.
You sure are? Because this is the way it works.
Isn't that neat?
When somebody puts something on the internet and it's so egregious, it's so horrible, it's so disgusting, riddled with lies and people are just making up shit as they go along. And they put your face to it, your name and all that garbage, right? Because they're pissed off at you or because they're vindictive. Who knows? Or they're sick in the head. Who cares? You flag the video. When the video doesn't come down and it's blatant terms of service violation, but for whatever reason, the artificial intelligence of YouTube overlooks it and says, oh, we don't see a violation.
Well,
let me ask you a question.
It is artificial
there,
intelligence.
Nikki,
that's
next?
Right.
Legal action.
Well, I think you got to flag
legal
down the Girl
action.
Scout cookie.
I hope you put
person.
Your nose. What?
Legal action.
Yeah, here, I'll pause it at 6:25. Yeah, like, so, and again, I'm still learning about this guy. So, I came across this video, which was a compilation of some 222 thing, right? I have no idea what the fuck that is. I don't even know who this nutcase is to begin with. So, I'm like watching it, and there's a little bit of information up, and it looks like it was back from 2015. And I'm wondering if he thinks that video is still up, because he talks about it like it is. That's why he's filing a federal lawsuit against Google, because he thinks the screen cap is a live video right now on YouTube, when it's really a part of a compilation video talking about like past shit that happened.
So what's funny is I haven't seen anything degenerate about this guy created by anybody other than him. That's the weird part of it. Like all of the nasty weirdo degeneracy I've seen was his own videos.
Right. And like the rough timeline that I can knock out, or at least how I understand how things are going right now. So Drummer made this video 10 years ago, right? And he was talking about a situation where somebody who knew Montagraph was involved in, like, he got catfished, right? This guy that Montagraph knew, I can't remember his name, but he got catfished go ahead.
With all that OPSEC and Human that they got on, that someone still got catfished?
It must have been super CIA agents, I'm guessing. I don't know. I mean, we'll find out how the feds are after them.
Or was it an inside job?
Oh, has Agent 19 turned? Well, we'll never know, I guess. But no, so the guy that he knew got catfished by somebody claiming to be like an underage girl. And everybody's like, oh, this guy's like a Ubifile. He's like a pedo or something. And Drummer made a video about it, talking about it, and, you know, people at the time were saying, well, Montagraph is defending this guy, he won't throw him under the bus. And, like, that starts this weird thing, and then, like, 4 or 5 years later after that, there's this weird shit with 222 Gang, where he gets brought up again with, like, some weird sex shit. He's got videos up there of, like, a girl in bondage gear with a pig mask on. You know, I don't know what the fuck that was about, but that's another thing. You know, it's just, there's a lot of weird shit, but there's only like bits and pieces of it left. You know what I mean? Like I get the feeling he flagged down a lot of it. So, I guess to wrap it up, he's convinced, or at least I believe he thinks that this video, this 222 thing is still up on Google. No, man, it was on somebody's account. It's a compilation video and it's talking about it, but it's only got like 3 minutes worth of shit because he's flagged everything down. So we'll kick it back off at 6:25. Let's go.
I hope you read every last word, and do me a big favor. Be sure to read mine. I'd be the plaintiff. Apparently, Mr. Hampton doesn't know who the plaintiff and the defendant is. We had to learn some on that. So hopefully, you're learning these matters. Please read the plaintiff's. In that case, read the summation. That wraps it all up. Save yourself a lot of time.
And can I read the insemination instead?
I'm giving you full permission right now because you probably already did it. You're going to pull my record and it's going to be pristine.
I'm going to pause it right here. This I thought was weird too at 7:08. What he said, you're going to do this. You're going to pull my record. Well, you're a lawyer, yeah, but how are you going to get, like, what is he talking, like, pull my record? Like, you have magical knowledge of who he is exactly, his location, his full name, and you're going to pull his record.
I have no idea. Well, other than knowing that he's like Stephen Quest or whatever, I don't know if he's related to Johnny Quest.
Well, let me just say this in regards to the Stephen Quest thing. I mean, that is on the legal documents we're going to be reading. But I found a video from 10 years ago, right? It could even be older. It was from Blog TV. I got a clip of it later on. I'll play it. Where he says that Steve Quest, that name, is a DBA, do business as alias. That's not his real name. And the thing is, when you look at the legal documents, the address he lists for the filing, you know, like his name, and then he gives his address, it's a fucking TJ Maxx.
Well, but I mean, he might be in a dressing room in all these videos, to be fair.
Well, it could be dressing room 127. I mean, you're correct about that, but I don't know if that's his real name. And the fact that he's filing, his own, lawsuits against people from fucking TJ Maxx makes me think that maybe Steve Quest, can you use a DBA? Is that even a thing? Can you even use that on a lawsuit?
I mean, if you're suing on behalf of an organization, sure. But as an individual, no. The plaintiff has to list their legal name, right? You don't, unless they, I guess, manifest to the court some sort of need for anonymity, and there's a process for that. You have to file a motion for it. You file it, so it's a confidential motion requesting protection, identity protection from the court, and then you'd get to file as a John Doe. You wouldn't get to file as a DBA unless you're filing on behalf of an entity that uses a DBA. Maybe he's like a cool sovereign citizen corporate person.
There's definitely some sovereign citizen shit going on here. He makes a very clear distinction between his legal name and his other names. So,
oh, good.
Yeah, that's kind of what we're dealing with. But what I find, we'll talk about it too when we get to the Morfonia stuff. But, you know, Jake is like, yeah, I filed my countersuit against him, and I got him under perjury to say that he was Steve Quest. Now, if his name isn't that, if he filed a bullshit lawsuit with a fake name and a fake address, and then he told the court, this is really who I am, is he putting himself out for legal trouble if Jake were to pursue that?
Yeah, well, that would be perjury, and pursuing it with the court could involve criminal charges against him. It's unlikely, just because the court would be like, oh my God, get the weirdo out of here, please. Right. We have real stuff to deal with, but it's certainly possible. And if he were to keep, I think the real issue would be is if he were to keep pushing the issue against the other guy, that would be what would piss the court off enough to really look into it.
Because he went to the court case, like, right. he went with somebody else, maybe Agent 19, and you know, like, Jake was like, yeah, we went to the court, and the judge kind of basically laughed at him. But like, I guess that's the other thing too, from what my understanding is, you know, from all those DUIs, when you go into court, you usually have to show a photo ID to get through the security checkpoint. So I mean, if he did use a fake name on his lawsuit, but then he went to court, wouldn't there be a log of who showed up around that time that they could cross check if Jake wanted to pursue that?
Yeah. And then you might find his true name and have power over him.
Right. Cause it seems crazy to me that somebody would use a fake name and address, go to court, and then try to sue somebody with a DBA and an alias. So again, this is all, I don't know. All I know is he identifies by like five different names and people have given him five different names. But he himself claims, and he's claimed for a decade, that Steve Quest, the name that he put on the lawsuit, is a fake name. It's an alias. He uses it for business only.
It's ballsy, and if I had to guess, he's familiar with balls. the other thing I do want to say, there is no magical like attorney resource for looking people up, looking people's record up. I mean, I could go through the same channels as anybody else to request a criminal background check on someone. And no, I didn't do it and probably wouldn't because what purpose would there be?
I figured it'd be harder for you guys. I mean, like debt collectors have access to a special national database where you can put in like just barely any information and get everything. Like a debt collector could probably get more information on him than a fucking lawyer could. Like it struck me as really weird that he's like, oh, you're going to get all this information on me. I'm like, what is he talking about?
Yeah. I mean, I'd have to pay for a BCA report just like anybody else. There's no special backdoor for attorneys. He did insinuate that the backdoor is always open, but not for attorneys.
Yeah, well, I mean, you are a handsome man. Can you really blame him? He put you in that bondage gear. But we'll pick up again at 7:08. Sound good?
Yeah, sounds great.
All right, let's go.
I have a blemish on it. You're going to also see that I worked in telecommunications for over 21 years.
21.
A lot of those years was a PBX programmer for federal facilities like Raytheon.
Raytheon's a private company.
Oh, yeah, I'll pause it again real quick. Yeah, again, right? He tells these stories about having super like secret security clearance, and he'll be like, I work for the government. I work for the FBI and the CIA and all, and Raytheon. And then he'll say, and I took the CIA down. Like, he'll say that he worked for DeepSec, you know, like a Deep State, whatever. And then he'll say that he destroyed Deep State. So, like, I don't know which one to go with. Is he the super secret agent? Or is he the rebel taking the government down?
He took down the deep state so he could rebuild it in his own image.
Apparently, that's what he's up to. All right, 7:25, let's go.
Mm-hmm. The FBI, GTE. I'm not a dummy, dude, so I understand every last detail when it comes to that telephone. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have an really exciting announcement.
Are you excited? I am.
When Mr. Anti-Bully decided to put the 222 JB Smeary garbage upon his Twitter account, Nikki over here,
Nikki,
the head counsel,
head counsel
for the sweaty sausage squad, decided to put his hand in the ring, even though he had no idea what he was commenting about.
That's true.
Shame on you, buddy.
Shame on me.
What did I do? I picked up the telephone and gave Nikki a call.
Ooh.
Sure did.
Yep.
Pay attention, Nikki, because I'm gonna relinquish the future to you.
And relinquish
you
it.
Exactly.
Well, now I get to have control. That's great.
It's going to happen.
He's a very giving man.
Minnesota is a one-party state. Colorado is also a one-party state. I am not required to give the two-party notification. No, I'm not. But because
why'd you
I'm a
do
nice
it then?
Person.
I'll pause it at 8:42. Did he give you like a mini Miranda? Did he say, hey, I'm recording you?
He said, you know, he asked if he had my consent to record. And then he just started talking right away. So it took me a second to actually process what was going on and respond. So he was talking. I started answering. I said, wait a minute. I don't consent to being recorded just in case you're in a two-party state. Because shockingly, I don't know. Other than I know Minnesota is a one-party state because that's the only one that typically matters to me, but I don't know that California or Colorado is one or two parties. So I said, just in case it's a two-party, I don't consent. But
well,
he's making
that's the thing too. I mean, I don't even know if he's from Colorado. Like with the fake address from TJ Maxx, who knows?
Sure. Yeah, and I who knows where he is when he's doing this? He could be in any TJ Maxx, really.
And any dressing room, you never know, lurking behind the clothing.
And so, I just don't consent to things. Like if a cop asks me to search my car, I don't consent. Whether I have something or not, it doesn't matter. And I give the same advice to clients. Like why make things easier for people? But he's making a big deal out of this two-party consent rule that he's going to cite. And it's like, well, I mean, I guess.
Well, he did work for Raytheon. I mean, he is the expert on two-party consent phone recordings.
Yeah, exactly. He definitely programmed all of Raytheon's two-party phones or whatever.
Oh, I mean, yeah, he was in charge of that. Like, that's why you're jealous of him, I think. Okay.
It is.
It kind of bleeds through a little bit. It's a little shameful, but I mean, I still like you.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
All right.
I have my flaws.
All right. 842. Let's go.
I, in fact, gave you the two-party notification at the very beginning of the call under the rules of engagement in telecommunications law.
It's not a rule of engagement.
It works like this. If a two-party notification is given, you have two choices. Keep running your mouth or hang up.
That's not true.
You kept running
your
mouth.
That is absolutely not true.
Oh, well, we'll pause it again at 9:05. Okay. Let's say that maybe you're confused and you don't understand that this guy was in charge, again, of Raytheon's phone protocols. But we're talking rules of engagement, Nikki. This is a fucking internet war. I don't know if you're aware, but you're dealing with a mastermind here. I mean, this guy is, look at him. He's a fucking genius, really.
Well, I'm going to have to call my direct contact to Donald Rumsfeld and find out what the rules of engagement are.
Are you? yeah, I don't. I'm fairly certain there's not something called the rules of engagement when it comes to fucking phone conversations. That's a new one on me. But what's your take on it?
You're in a one party state, which requires one party to the communication to offer their consent to the recording. So if it's you and someone else, then you have to give the consent, and that's fine. You can record the call as long as it's the state where the recording is being made as well. So if it were me, I could have recorded this without his consent because I have mine. And if Colorado is a one party state, as he says, which I'm inclined to doubt whatever he says, just out of principle, but if it's true, then he's able to record the call, whether I consent or not. Now, if you're in a two party state, you must attain the consent of both parties, or you have to stop the recording and delete whatever you have immediately. Otherwise, it is illegal to produce that recording or to publish it or to try and use it for any sort of purpose. So, and technically to possess it, but how would anybody ultimately know? But there's no like, well, if you're in a one party state and you do give a consent thing, that there's a rule that says you have to do this or do that. No, they can just record the call. That's so I guess he's right that I could hang up the phone, but I really wanted to talk to him. I was lonely.
Well, I mean, you heard the man, Nikki. I've noticed that when certain people, he kind of fits into this category, get mad, they end a Y, or they add a Y to the end of the name. Like, you're no longer Nick, you're Nikki. So you know that you're fucking in trouble dealing with this dude. But yeah, he said, I mean, you heard him. You had to keep running your fucking mouth, and now you're going to suffer because you're going to find out what he's got in store for you. And
oh,
it's,
God.
It's pretty spooky.
Worst thing in my life would be him publishing that phone call. I'll look so bad.
Oh no, that's just step one. He's got more steps in this master plan, but we'll continue on at 9:05. Let's go.
3/4 of the way into the call, you said something a little naughty. You said something that you believed may haunt you later. And it was at
naughty
that
boy.
Time that you told me to stop recording, in which I did. So let me tell you what's going to happen there, Nikki. I'm going to release that audio recording to the
public. Oh, no, not the public.
All the way up to the area which you tell me to stop.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll pause it at 9:32. What do you mean, no?
I tell him to stop. Why would I tell him to stop? What kind of weird thing is this where he's going to do what I don't want until I tell him not to?
I guess you got a good, it's a good point, right? Like, you get into a bar fight with somebody, you're like, I'm going to keep hitting you until you say no. Okay, all right. Like, what, you know, in for a pound, in for a penny. What are we doing here?
This is the most
bizarre,
baffling thing that I haven't been on the internet that long.
No, this dude's a special case. Like, you know, when I looked into the drummer stuff and I did my first stream on him, I said, you know, this is a dude that if you laugh at him or you talk about the goofy shit he does, he's putting you on a list. And all you did was one tweet, and 5 minutes later, he's recording a phone call with you. And now he's going to teach, he's going to destroy you because you tweeted out at me saying, basically, LOL, good luck getting sued.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, and again, I can't reiterate enough. I hadn't kept up with your tweets or videos or anything that you've said about this guy, which I think is just tweets up to this point, and maybe some clips of him in those tweets.
Essentially, yeah. That's basically all it is.
I mean, I had seen him go by a couple times, but you know, I've got so many weebs with the Twitters right now.
Oh, yeah, you got your own rules of engagement weeb war going on right now.
Yeah, exactly. So I hadn't followed it up. So when this guy calls me up and says, "Hello, I'm Montagraph from Twitter," I'm like, all right, I thought he was going to talk to me about Vic's case. I literally have no. I thought he was going to say, "Did you see what Monica Rial or Ron Toye said today?" So that's the mindset that I was in receiving a phone call, because those are phone calls that I actually get.
Wait, is that your strategy going forward? And the next time he calls you, are you going to talk about your favorite anime and just see how he goes with it?
I'm gonna pull up a bunch of yaoi titles that I think he's definitely watching and reading, and I'm just gonna ask him. I'm going to ask him who his husbandu is or whatever.
That's a difficult question for a man that likes putting people in bondage gear and having them suck toes on Twitter. So he's going to have an interesting answer, I'm sure, on that one.
I hope so.
Yeah, we got like 6 more minutes.
Yeah, let's do it.
His master plan's coming up. We'll go back at 9:32 and go.
Because I committed no crimes, I gave you the two-party notification, and it is clear as a bell. If you feel that you're going to use what is called professional courtesy in your jurisdiction to open up an investigation against me for violating wiretap laws,
I don't know.
They're going to do that investigation. They're going to laugh at you, and nothing's going to happen.
Can we pause it real quick?
Yeah, of course.
Why on earth would I open up a wire investigation over a phone call? My God, my day was not ruined by some weirdo calling me. I'm a lawyer. I have weirdos call me all the time. Like, what? They're called other lawyers usually, but do people do this? Like, is that a thing where you, like Jim, you get a phone call sometime? Mm-hmm. Are you calling up your local district attorney, being like, "Look, I need you to extend some professional courtesy and open a federal wire investigation into this phone call I got"?
Well, I mean, you could always try. God, I know it's a weird strategy, but if it really bothers you, don't pick the phone up.
Yeah, or block the number, or it's any number of strategies I could have employed. Why would anybody? Okay, sorry. I'm just
no. It is. He strikes me as a what he sees as like a big fish in a small pond kind of scenario. This is a shit. This is kind of what I saw happen with his history throughout the internet. Is he would do this stuff to people to like try to, I guess, intimidate them. Like, oh hey, I can call you, Nikki. I know what your phone number is, so you're fucking with the wrong one kind of mindset. And he's kind of running into people now that don't really care. And I don't think he knows how to respond to that. Like, it's fucking him up.
My phone number is on my – you just Google Rekieta Law, and you can find my law office's phone number. This is not like I wonder if he thinks that I think he did some super docs to find my publicly available phone number that I put out for advertisement purposes.
Well, yeah, this guy treats Spokio like it's a fucking dowsing rod. Like, he acts like a Google Maps is like some second sight kind of shit with his psychic powers. Like, he made a video about Drummer where he took an 8-year-old video of some place that Drummer used to live. And then he like overlaid Google Maps on it. And he's like, my psychic powers pinpointed you. and the funny thing with the Drummer thing is he gets all these docs together, right? This address, names, and everything. It's the wrong guy. Drummer doesn't he doesn't live there anymore. He's going after the guy that lives there right now. So Drummer like archives all of this, puts it on a little flash drive, gets a hold of the guy, and he's like, yeah, you know, this nutcase on the internet is like smearing your name, and he's saying he's gonna come after you and do all this shit to you. Here's a flash drive with everything, you know. And he titled it Free Money. And he gave it to the guy. He's not really impressive when you look at his super hacking abilities, let's just say.
Mm.
Okay.
I'm shocked.
We'll continue off 9:55 and go.
By chance, the professional courtesy goes from your state to my state, and my state comes by and gives me a little ticket, says show up in court. I'm not the plea bargain guy. Let's go to trial.
It'd be your state. I don't care bargains. What you do.
We don't do plea bargains. Isn't that neat?
That's neat.
That sure neat. Is.
So pay attention, Nick. Don't get pissed off when that audio recording is splashed all over the internet and tens of thousands of people.
Hold on.
Okay.
press X to doubt on tens of thousands of people hearing anything Montagraph puts out.
you're fucking with a thunder here. I've seen his live streams. He gets in at least a good 20 people watching. So your reputation's over, buddy.
It's done.
It's done. You might as well just drink yourself to death right now.
Oh, thank God. I've been waiting for this moment.
Have you? Just open the bottle up. Just let it take over. Okay, we'll continue off 10:25.
I haven't even brought in my allies yet. It's just little old me and Agent 19 for now. Isn't this fun? I mean, you guys want to be superstars. You want to be famous. We're going
to
help you out.
Who wants to be famous?
Oh, let me pause it. 10:42. Yeah, okay, so he made a threat. He made a threat to me earlier. He's like, I'm going to make you famous. And so my response was, awesome, do it. Yeah. I think that's now he thinks you're that same mindset, so he's gonna make you famous too.
But I mean, it would be devastating if more people found out about my public videos and YouTube channel. God, I would hate it.
I know,
I would hate it.
It's terrible. I mean, I know that it's a burden for you to have to live stream in front of like 10,000 people and make super chat money. Hopefully, you know, he doesn't double that, because Jesus, what a hardship that would be.
It'd be a real shame.
All right, 10:42, let's go.
That call will be released. It sure will be. Uh-huh. And people of your profession can see the way you treated me.
Oh, good.
They can hear the expression in your voice on how you talk to the public when they are simply trying to defend themselves through gross, and I mean gross, horrific defamation.
Defecation, you mean.
You got that there, Nikki?
Nikki?
I'll tell you what's going to happen after that. I'm going to make tons of memes.
Tons of them.
Not the memes.
Don't get upset when you see your face and your law firm everywhere. Don't be upset.
I look at my face
because
every night.
After all, it will be parody, right?
Yes.
Back at you, bud. Back at you.
I don't think I said his stuff
We're
was parody.
We're going to learn you, buddy, how this is done.
I don't know. He's so crazy.
We're going to learn you real good. And you'll never forget my name as long as you live. Nikki, and you have inserted yourself into this mess because you want to go sniff Mr. Anti-Bully's toes.
Ooh, those are some...
Is that right?
Fragrant toes you got there.
Yeah, let me. I'll pause it at 11:55. Yeah, he's got something with toes. I don't know what it is, but a lot of the... Like, he keeps making tweets and then deleting them where he talks about sucking on toes. I don't know if that's a... It's a weird projection. I don't understand it.
I've got to warn you, Jim. I have 5 kids. I'm pretty good at inserting myself. So you better perfume up those toes and get ready.
it's fucking coming. It's coming. Yeah, he nailed you 100% with this. This meme is some hot shit. All right, 11:55. Let's go.
Okay. Good. Don't be upset when that audio drops.
I won't be upset.
Don't cry.
Literally
don't whine.
Will not cry
do
or whine.
Something. I want you to.
Do what?
You want me to? I don't know.
Here's the thing there, Nikki. Pay attention. I'm not a Q boomer. Stop running your mouth. You don't
Oh, you're a Q boomer, all right. Whatever that is.
He's absolutely
Q is
a boomer.
Fraud. Go print that.
Print it, Nikki.
Q has been a fraud since
I hit print just now.
Thanksgiving of 2017. Because it was taken over by an Australian company. Dude, don't make me learns you in public. It's going to be extremely embarrassing.
What do I have to pay to be learns in private?
Like double. I said, I Please haven't double. Even pulled any favors yet. It's going to get real good real soon. It sure is. But here's the thing, Nikki. I'm not going to snap. You'd wish
nope.
I'd snap. But I'm not going to. How I'm going to deal with all of this is drag people in the courtroom under
civil torts.
And if necessary... Include you in it, seeing that you want to be
hope there's some Pop-Tarts in there.
Think that the general public is afraid of you when we're not. And here's another thing there, Nikki.
Oh, here it comes.
Seeing that you're so quick to jump in a pool.
Here's his plan.
Where you don't have any of the information, you're only going
That's
on
true.
Hearsay. You're only going on what people are saying to you
yep.
in tweets. You're only going on what you've heard because you didn't investigate, because you're lazy.
I was driving, to be fair.
You're calling me a Q boomer, and I'm the guy that busted Q.
I've never called him a Q boomer until now.
Well, let me. I'm going to pause it at 1341. I've been referring to him as a Q LARPer. all right, chat. Here's the real story, as far as I understand it. Okay, this dude is 100% in favor of Q. All right, he is the super Q boomer, and he loves Q. Don't listen to what he's saying; it's all deep cover bullshit. He is the Q boomer supreme, and Nikki here in that secretly recorded audio just kept screaming Q boomer at him for like 20 minutes during that drive. Isn't that right?
That's actually the truth. I'm ashamed to say.
you've been busted. Oh, yeah. Now, here's where he's going to reveal his, I think this should be coming up in like a few seconds, his master plan. This is how he's really going to fuck you into the dirt. So we'll continue off at 1341.
Yeah. And identified the person that was Q. Sorry. Electronically. Can back it up electronically.
Back it up.
And you're sitting over there. With that big man, you got a big old nose. You know what? I was thinking.
He figured out I had a big nose.
Turn you upside down and turning that nose into a planter. I could put like two little flowers in there and just,
just get a garden in your face.
Oh, that'd be great.
You can laugh at yourself.
Yes,
can't you?
I can.
I can, because I tell you what, ask around. I'm going to start making memes. It's going to be hysterical.
Has he seen Roxanne with Steve Martin?
Is. Because you, probably. Nikki. Are the head counsel for the Sweaty Sausage Squad.
Ooh, no.
You know what? We're going to make a whole new website just for you.
There it is.
I'm going to change your banner. I'm going to change Twitter. It's going to be tons of fun. I hope you can laugh at yourself. I'm sure that Mr. Anti-Bully will love it.
Yes, I will.
I'm positive all these other troll parts.
Absolutely.
They're accusing me of shit I never did in a million years. I bet you even they will laugh at memes I'm going to make.
God, I hope so.
It's going to be
if you're going to work that hard.
He's building your own website.
I saw one of your shows. What a yarn.
I won't do it, so somebody has to.
When you said a small attorney's firm in Minnesota, man, you ain't
kidding. I'm not kidding at all.
You're absolutely right about that.
Probably the smallest one you'll find.
The problem with Mr. Anti-Bully, he doesn't know his enemy. He doesn't know, because I'm his enemy now.
Oh, he's declared it.
Because he's accused me of shit I'd never do in a million years.
What did you accuse him of?
You're my enemy now because...
Oh, I'll pause it. We're almost done anyway. 1523. The only things I've accused him of are the things that I've seen him actually do and that are archived, which is admitting to doxing people, admitting to flagging people, admitting to suing people, and claiming in audio on stream that he called the police on people. Like, I've not accused him of doing anything which he has not explicitly himself stated he has done. As in regards to the 222 thing, I made no declarative statements with that. I merely said, boy, this rabbit hole is getting dark. So I guess he's imagining I'm saying things that I'm not saying, even though I'm not the one deleting tweets. He is.
But is the melon hole getting dark?
Oh, it's going to be getting dark. We're getting to the melons pretty quick here.
Oh, God.
We got like a minute left. We'll just let it play through.
1523. That shit you said on your phone call, dummy. And I don't care what you're going to do about it. You know what's really neat? I've got a bunch of servers up there in Minnesota. Maybe I can swing by and visit you and all. We can go to lunch. Would you like
that? Yeah, I'd go to lunch.
Go out for a couple of beers and that. Hang out on the lake. Smoke a couple of cigars.
Yeah.
You can tell me how wonderful you're not.
Okay.
I'm just merely defending myself.
Sounds like a date.
Against jackasses like an attorney like yourself. Nikki.
Attorneys are the worst.
A tiny, teeny weeny, itsy bitsy, puny woony law firm
puny
in the state of Minnesota. It is going to get so much attention when your audio drops of the way you're talking to me because I'm nearly trying to defend myself.
God, I wish it would have been meaner.
That is all, Nikki. See you on the other side. Oh, don't take that the wrong way. Ooh, sorry. I mean, I'll see you on the other side of the interwebs. Settle down.
I was hoping you meant on the other side of my underwear or something.
Oh, hey, getting a little dirty there.
This guy promised to take me to dinner, take me out on the lake, give me some beer and a cigarette. He better own up to that.
Well, you know, I mean, he is a romantic. I can't deny the fact that this man, he's a sweetheart. Maybe he should be in charge of the sweetie squad.
If he brings the beer and cigars, I'll bring the Bluetooth speaker and the Barry White playlist.
So that was a kind of a compilation for people that weren't really familiar with who Montagraph is. Like, that's what you saw in those videos. That's what I've been watching for the past month, what he would do to Drummer. And then when I finally talked about it, much like he did to you, after just mentioning like once or twice, suddenly I'm on the shit list. I'm getting sued. Servers are going to come subpoena me. Google's going to, you know, bow to his will kind of shit. But this isn't, you know, like these aren't empty threats, I guess is the way I should put it. Because he has tried to file legal motions before. If you want to pull up the link I gave you and we'll just kind of go through it. Maybe you can give us your opinion as you read through it.
Yeah, these are the whatchamacallit, the Blackstone Intelligence Network one.
Yeah, I'll read the page and then we'll look through the filing from him and then the counter filing, I guess, from Morphonius.
Sure.
It shouldn't take too, like, Morphonius. Okay, just so everybody knows, they're both representing themselves. I don't know if Morphonius has a legal background or if he consulted with a lawyer before he sent stuff in, but like he sent in a 23-page reply, right? But when we look at what Steve sent in, what Montagraph sent in, it's like 4 pages and 2 of them are blank. I don't know. You know, like it's just really weird to me. So let me pull that up and then we'll go through that. And I think people are going to really like the Mellon stuff. So we'll do that. Just give me 1 second here.
Sure.
Okay. Hopefully, I mean, God, how are you holding up? I guess are you shook? Are you scared right now?
A little bit. I'm a little scared. I'm sad. I'm sad that I lost all my guns in the lake years ago. I'm worried about what my family will think of me when they see the memes.
Well, he likes to remind people that he lives in a stand your ground state. Like he said this in a couple other streams, where he's like, I've got 3 guns. It's stand your ground. Do it. Try me, Nicky. it's something else.
The hardest part is the disappointment on my children's faces.
I know it's hard to live with. Okay, I think I've got this pulled up. Yeah, it's the Blackstone Intel and Montagraph thing, and okay. People will see the link. If you guys want to check it out on your own and just read through the crazy, feel free to. I guess the guy that runs it put it up for everybody to see what this guy's like. So let's take a look through. Okay. So I'll just read through and we'll get to the legal filings, I guess. Blackstone Intelligence Network, Morphonius defeats Quest. Notorious cyberstalker meets his match. For over a decade, an online cyberstalker going by the name Montagram harassed, bullied, threatened untold numbers of victims. The internet is rife with complaints from his victims who suffered from serial abuse that they felt they could do nothing about. Montagraph used other names including Umbrella Man, Elite Rule, October Reigns, I'm Your Ghost, and often partnered with another anonymous troll who hides behind the name Agent 19. Some wondered if Montagraph's real name was actually Steve Quest or Dale Ellis Bennett, among others, but they could never be certain. Montagraph repeatedly denied being either of these men. This uncertainty made it nearly impossible for victims to sue their abuser. In April of 2019, Montagraph decided to target Jake Morphonius during a live broadcast of the Blackstone Intelligence Network. As he discussed the need to show empathy and civility towards the parents of children who were slain in the Sandy Hook school shooting. So just so people are familiar, what started this? Apparently Jake said, hey, try to be nice to people whose kids got killed. And Montagraph took offense to that and was like, fuck them! So I guess that was the touchstone. Montagraph was banned by moderators, but repeatedly cycled through multiple user accounts pretending to be different people. In response to the harassment, Morphonius advised his audience to look up the ample evidence of Montagraph's unethical and deviant activities. They sent Montagraph into a rage. Over the next 24 hours, he made multiple threats to travel to Morphonius' home to confront him face-to-face. Morphonius advised Montagraph that further threats would result in court action to preempt such action and hoping to generate some degree of internet fame for himself by attacking a much more popular personality. Montagraph filed a frivolous defamation lawsuit against Morphonius. So should we open that up? Do you want to take a look at the original filing?
Yep.
That should be the C. Steve Quest original complaint.
Yeah. This is one of those great pro se forms that you go down to the court administrator and get, and you get to scrawl in with your excellent handwriting on the 3 lines they give you to explain your cause of action.
And to be fair, I believe these are legitimate court documents, but I don't know how to look through a court system to double check. But I'm going to guess that because Morphonius went through all this trouble, these are legit what he had filed against him and what he filed in response.
They look very legit. They've got the seal on there from the clerk of court. It'd be really annoying to file to try and
But I would want to point out this, the address that's listed here. Because somebody said it's a bullshit address, so I double checked it, and it really goes, it's a fucking TJ Maxx. So I don't know what to make of that.
Is that number 127 through 245?
Well, you never know. Yeah, you never know where he is. I mean, he could be in dressing room 127 or maybe 245. You just don't know. You got to show up to find out, really.
Is he like a mall cop and he could just be anywhere in that strip center?
Steve Quest is Paul Blart. Yeah, I mean, potentially. you got all this chicken scrawl. It gives the notice of summons, I guess. The county they're suing in, this is all first page stuff. I'm guessing this is real basic shit when you do a pro se, right? With the
yeah, they just give you this form and you fill out the relevant parts, and I mean, you could use it with an attorney, but you should fire that person immediately.
This is a summons then, right? This is what's being issued.
Oh, let's see. So yeah, here's the summons, and this is just to tell you when to show up. And the complaint will be starting on page 3.
Okay, but here's what I'm curious about. Like, starting on page 2, everything under the affidavit of service, nothing's filled out. There's no declaration that they're 18 and older.
Yeah, and so your summons is page 1, and then the affidavit of service is something you would turn in. And if you we're jumping ahead, but if you check out the defendant's answer, or not the defendant's answer, but the motion to dismiss that he filed, he did cite an improper or lack of service that it should be dismissed for lack of service. So I didn't read through it all. I skimmed that document, so maybe we'll get to it. But
that
looks like a problem.
Yeah, like on page 3 under subsection 4, I guess this is his claim. Jake Morphonius accused me of vile and disgusting acts during a live broadcast on his Blackstone Intelligence channel, defaming my character, in which thousands of people heard this publicly. I don't know. How does that, is that fine? Like, I don't know how these work. So is that good enough when you're sending this in?
No. You would have to probably list out the specific statements. Typically, you'd have to say, if you're only going to use 4 lines, it's like he punched me in the face on February of 2018 at this location, type thing. So that's where you get this 4 thing. If you're going to talk about a defamation lawsuit, you're going to have to lay out the defamatory statements in your complaint, typically, or you're going to have to specifically say that the accusations are false, which he doesn't do, right? It just says he accused him of vile and disgusting acts.
Right.
Well, were they true? Because you can accuse people of true things all day. If they're false, then you have to state that they're false. And if you don't, then there's no remedy that the court can provide.
Right. And then he's suing him for $25K, which, I mean, that obviously kicks it out of small claims, right? So this would be right. Or I don't know how any of this works. So you're the guy that would know this shit on section 3. Well, that's what the amount he wanted.
Those are state specific. I would assume he picked 25,000 to be out of small claims and within the rules of whatever court it is. Otherwise I don't know how he gets to $25,000. So, wait, so this is in North Carolina. That's the PO box of Morphonius. Okay. Never mind.
I think Morphonius says what court they were in. I think this is they're doing this in
Golden, Colorado.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It would have to be out of small claims court. Typically small claims have to be filed in the jurisdiction of the defendant where they reside.
Okay.
Or maybe work. So,
and then it says too under subsection 6 on page 3, does not want a trial by jury. So, I mean, what do you think he imagined that he was going to send this in and say, I want $25,000 because he said mean things and I don't want a jury trial? Did he think the judge was going to be like, granted, Mr. TJ Maxx, here's your money?
Yeah, I think he did. I think he said, well, I've got such a solid legal case. This is legally defamatory. And therefore, I'm going to just win it and not use a jury as a fact finder. I'm going to just go with the judge.
Yeah, and there's, and like, I again, you know, on the last two pages, 5 and 6, I guess, like, there's, it just seems like he didn't fill out a lot of stuff. I don't know, again, if that's normal or not, but there's a lot of blank spaces all over this fucking thing.
Okay, 5 and 6 look like the answer document that you would give to your opponent to allow them to have a form to handle or to fill out and return if they wanted to use it.
Oh, I got you.
So, okay. So that must be why he left it blank, other than to just start to fill out the caption.
Okay, that makes sense. All right, so that was his initial complaint. Morphonius responded to Quest's complaint with a well-articulated motion to dismiss, citing ample case law. We'll wait a second before we jump into that, just because I want to read to them the exhibits. Is that cool with you?
Yep, I'm fine with it.
In the process, Montagraph was forced, and this is the other thing, Montagraph was forced to confirm under penalty of law that he is in fact Steve Quest, a resident of Lakewood, Colorado, who changed his name in Jefferson County from Roy Warren Marshall. There's much speculation as to the event that necessitated him doing this. By outing himself in court, Quest has given his victims a significant gift. They now have a real name to attach to their abuser. They no longer have to live with the fear and frustration of being targeted by an unidentified stalker who they cannot fight back against. Sorry, I've got a bit of... I guess that voodoo magic's getting to me. Monograph Quest has been making random threats for over a year that he was going to sue people, including big-name YouTubers. His handful of sycophants lapped up the armchair bravado, cheering him on. This stoked his ego, and after filing his suit, Quest went on to produce more than a dozen videos bragging about how he was going to destroy Morphonius in court, ruin him for life, take his last dollar, stomp on Morphonius relentlessly. Quest also began threatening other victims, telling them that he was going to do to them what he was doing to Morphonius. Quest invited his audience of 50,000 subscribers to come support him at the first court hearing, an act that was clearly intended to try to intimidate Morphonius. Morphonius, however, is not one who can be intimidated, least of all by a man who dresses in drag and tapes himself French-kissing children's dolls in scat fetish videos. See Exhibits 13 to 16, or who schemes how to make more money off homemade videos of himself sodomizing defenseless melons on camera, Exhibits 17 to 20. I love that
defenseless
he...
melons.
Sodomizing them. Brutally. Do you think that Jake had fun filing his counter notification with these exhibits included in all this shit? I'm guessing he did.
Oh, God, yeah. Yeah. I think he enjoyed that a little bit. I think he might have had his own melon with him.
Sexually abused melons. Okay, well, we'll jump back and look at Jake Morphonius' motion to dismiss. And you're the legal guy, so you can take the lead on this. Just tell me what page you're on so I can put it on screen for people. And we'll just, I guess, go through it, and you can give us your take on what you think on how he handled this in response to this particular guy.
Sure. Well, let's just briefly hit the introduction. It says defendant Jake Morphonius is an independent journalist with a background in financial crimes. Sorry, page one.
Okay, we're good. All right, go ahead.
With a background in financial crimes investigation, who investigates geopolitical conflicts in the Middle East as well as other topics, including political corruption and government cover-ups. Publishes his report primarily on his YouTube channel, Blackstone Intelligence Network. On April 6, 2019, defendant conducted a live broadcast discussing defamation lawsuits by parents of children who were killed in the 2012 Sandy Hook shooting. Defendant had interviewed Sandy Hook parents who lost children in the massacre and was talking to his audience about the importance of treating the grieving parents with compassion and civility, as opposed to the actions of anonymous internet trolls who tormented the parents of with false claims of them being paid crisis actors and that their children never actually died. During this broadcast, several anonymous trolls entered the online forum and began to disrupt the program. One provocateur cycled through multiple fake accounts during the broadcast. Defendant learned after the broadcast was over that some of these troll accounts were being operated by plaintiff Steve Quest and other unnamed associates. Okay, so that's the background, which he kind of covered in the other thing. But just to give the court a synopsis, I won't read all of this, but so sure. First his argument is that the defendant is not subject to personal jurisdiction in Colorado.
Okay.
So this means that the court doesn't have any right to bring Morphonius in front of the court, right? He's not a resident of Colorado, and unless he's doing business in Colorado or has some sort of sufficient contact within the state, like he's in the state while committing the act,
that would be a different story. But unless the you have some sort of nexus to the state to connect the defendant, they can't bring you in. You know, they can't just sue you in some state and expect you to show up. They have to show a reason why you should be expected to be in that state.
Okay.
So then he lays out the standard for exercising personal jurisdiction, which looks like he probably did some research. He's got lots of case law cited in here.
Yeah, I noticed it was really, at least to me, again, as a layman, it looked really thorough. I mean, he's got a lot of shit listed in his response.
And he's got, I mean, he's got the main cases you want to have. You want to have International Shoe. That's a long-established case. You want to have, what was it, Volkswagen is in here. Yeah, Worldwide Volkswagen Corp versus Woodson. These are. It's almost like he picked up a civil procedure book on jurisdiction, like a textbook, and just put the basic argument down from that. It's okay. Without reading through it, it is thorough and it's likely correct.
So would you say the I guess his counterfiling, at least the beginning of it, seems fairly decent? It's not crazy. I mean, it makes sense.
No, it makes a lot of sense. And he's either done his homework or he's friends with at least a law student, one of the two. You know, you get this argument is what you spend your first two semesters of law school learning in civil procedure.
That makes sense. Okay.
Yeah. So this, but it's very straightforward. And I mean, he might have gotten it from a website or something, but it's correct. So he just has to say, yeah, I'm not in Colorado ever. So why would I be there? Why would I go to court there? So general jurisdiction is inapplicable to client. So outside of having specific jurisdiction or personal jurisdiction over someone, you can have general jurisdiction over an act or transaction that occurred within a state. So like, obviously, if you're just driving through the corner of a state and you run someone over, then you could be brought into court in that state. That makes sense.
Yeah.
But that, you know, doesn't happen. Here, so no, not domiciled, nor continuous and systematic general business contacts with Colorado to warrant jurisdiction. So there's nothing tying him to the state. So specific jurisdiction is inapplicable to defendant, which is similar to his, or specific jurisdiction, sorry. General jurisdiction would be the sufficient contact with the forum. Specific jurisdiction would be with the transaction or act that occurred. And again, yeah, he's just saying that there's nothing that he did in Colorado.
Yeah, there's absolutely no reason you should be bringing me to this state for a lawsuit is essentially what the opening is.
Right. And then if we jump down to page 9, section D,
sure.
He's saying that even if they were to find jurisdiction, exercise of the jurisdiction would be unreasonable because there's no it would be. He's going to make the argument, I'm guessing, that it's unduly burdensome and unfair to bring him in. And he does have the correct legal standard. At the very bottom of page 9, he starts at the five-factor fairness test set forth in Asahi and Burger King. Exercise of this court would be unreasonable. And so then he goes through the 5 points and makes the argument. This is a very basic and very well-written legal motion to dismiss on these grounds.
Yeah, and it looks like you were talking about this earlier too when we were looking at the initial filing on the bottom of page 11, the invalid service of process.
Yep. So yeah, personal service must be made here. Now this might be, let's see. This might not be complete here. Typically, since he's not in Colorado, he might have to be served under the rules of service in his home state. A copy of the plaintiff's complaint was improperly served by a Forsyth County, North Carolina sheriff's deputy who left a copy of the complaint with defendant's minor child, age 16 years old, at his place of residence. Yeah, that doesn't work.
Okay.
Without knowing North Carolina's specific rules, if you're going to serve someone at their residence, you usually have to serve another adult at the residence.
They ended up serving his kid.
Yeah, the sheriff did. And the sheriff's deputy might have just done that on purpose. Like, this is stupid here.
Oh, I got you.
But who knows? Improper service. Plaintiff fails to state a claim. This is your typical almost every civil case is going to make this argument because it's a one-hitter quitter. argument. Failure to state a claim upon which relief can be granted. So they'll say the pleadings are not specific enough, which is true. And he goes through the justification as to why.
So far in his answer, he's basically said, suing me in this state doesn't make sense. You have no jurisdiction. You serve me improperly. And you're not even really... It seems like he's just going down the list of everything he could list when he's putting this in front of a judge, right?
Yeah, and he's doing it in the proper way. First of all, you don't have jurisdiction, so it should go. Next, even if you do have jurisdiction, it was served improperly, so I'm not appearing before the court yet. Next, if you find jurisdiction and you find service proper, this case fails for failure to state a claim. And then here at the bottom of 15, he asked for dismissal with prejudice based on frivolous and vexatious complaint. This is the part that I believe the court did not grant fully, because they did dismiss the lawsuit without prejudice. And that's because of the failure to properly serve and the lack of jurisdiction. They're not going to dismiss a suit with prejudice if it's not even served properly and there's no jurisdiction of the court to act.
Let's say, on the first try. Yeah. If this had been served properly against Morphonius, do you think the other answers in his counter notification were decent? Do you think the judge would have dismissed based on the other stuff?
Oh yeah. Yeah. That, he would either have dismissed it or he would have demanded that, Steve here, go ahead and issue an amended complaint that more fully lists out the pleading standards for defamation.
Oh yeah. And then he starts exhibits on page 16.
Yeah.
I'll read through a few of these. I guess these are exact quotes that he's listing at the bottom of the, or attached, whatever. Things like, you'll be ruined for life, dummy. You are an idiot. I will take your last dollar, motherfucker. fuck you. Get your checkbook ready. You have placed your livelihood in jeopardy. I'm going to financially ruin you and beyond.
Ooh.
Lots of this. Exhibit 5, what is this? After defendant responded to plaintiff's threats by saying that it's wrong to threaten women, plaintiff responded with an additional threat. Mr. Quest is coming for you. Bet on that. And then all capitalized, in person.
This dude is out of his mind. These are potentially actually criminally actionable threats.
It's a lot of exhibit 6. Sorry for your luck, Jake. I have your exact location. We'll be seeing you face to face. Sure will. You can show me how tough you are. Be prepared to be stomped on relentlessly.
Yeah, if you sent that to Minnesota, that would be potentially in Minnesota, if I say prepare to be stomped on relentlessly, that is a specific act of battery, and that would be considered a terroristic threat. That's a felony. In Minnesota.
Well, this guy's super smart, though. I mean, again, remember, he's the head of, what the fuck was it? Raytheon. There we go.
Now, the part of the felony standard would be that you'd have to prove that this was some sort of imminently executable threat, which seems unlikely because I'm not sure, if he could get out of TJ Maxx before his shift was over.
Well, that is true. Actually, let me see, because it goes right into conclusions. Oh, okay. Yeah, because I think that Morphonius filed a second, like a follow-up to this with more evidence.
I think he wanted to, but he didn't have to. So he filed his motion to dismiss, which was granted. And then if I read it right, he's got an answer that he was ready to file if the court denied his motion to dismiss.
Oh, and but then he, here, yeah, and then in the exhibits they have the screen caps of all the, like statements. I've always wondered about this when you're filing something like this and you're including exhibits. Is a screen cap good enough? I mean, should he have archives of it as well? Like, what if he deletes it? How does that work?
Archives are better than screen caps. Either way, doesn't matter what you have. You'll have to, in a civil suit, you'll have to authenticate it. In a criminal suit, they'll go through the process of authenticating it. So you'd have to ask him about it and see if he made it. And if he refuses to do that, then you have to have some sort of expert in YouTubery come on and talk about how this is his account. This is not easy to fake, and that this statement was made, and you'd basically make the argument that this is an authentic statement, or you get him to admit it, like in a deposition or something. But yeah, the archives are better because they're harder to, they're much harder to fake than a screenshot.
Okay, all right. Let me back out of this one then, because that was the counter notification. I wanted to see if we could find Oh, okay, yeah. So he maybe he lists these as second or like separate documents, or these are on something else. I mean, this is a really long one. Yeah, this must be the. This is a 3-hour. Yeah, he's talking about the broadcast he did with the threats and everything, and the melon fucking. I think is included in it. I just want to find that to show people what he had on that. He's got the two girls, one cup video where he's eating pudding and making it look like a shit. Sucking on Barbie dolls. It's just all over the place. Yeah, and I know that more. God, their names are so close. Montagraph had said that you don't know who I am. You're putting my name out there. But he did a Google search for Montagraph, and then with the search term pedophile, and a bunch of links popped up. Is that to show that he's not the one that started it, but that's something that already exists out there?
Yeah, that would be the thing there. I'm just reporting on who this person. It's also a coy way to
get it entered into evidence.
Yeah, I don't want to say to prejudice the judge, but to prejudice the judge a little bit, because the judge is going to look at this and go, "Oh dear Christ, what is this?"
Oh, and Exhibit 11. Okay, this I guess goes to his name, right? I can you tell me what the hell this is? This would be. Let me make sure. Like if you click on Exhibits 13 to 16, right, the document that pops up. Exhibit 11, which would be on page 26.
Yeah.
It says in the matter of, and then it lists Roy Warrett Marshall. What am I looking at? Is this him trying to say this is a name change, or what exactly is this document?
I'm going to guess this is the name change.
Okay. And that's so he somehow tracked it down.
Right. So he's referencing the file here. I mean, to be ultimately thorough, I guess you would want to get a copy of the name change document and attach it to here. But, you know, this is probably sufficient. Oh, yeah. So Marshall Roy Warren, petitioner number one, and date of birth, gender unknown, race, blah, blah, blah. Quest Steve K.A., petitioner two. So that I'm guessing that's just how they file those name change things. It's weird because you like in some states I believe you do sue your own name.
Oh, is that what you sue yourself to change it? Yeah,
it's weird. It should just be an administrative process, but it is a legal name change. So,
okay.
I'm guessing that's just how they have this listed in 1996. But you know, anybody could actually go. Here's the case number and the county, Jefferson County. You could actually go and probably request a copy of these documents, but you might have to do it in person because they're old.
Okay. Yeah, and then back on the main thing to kind of wrap it up with this particular back and forth of them. To try to capitalize on the spectacle he was creating, Quest hoped to record the court proceedings for his audience. Only one supporter had shown up, so unless he could record the court case to broadcast, nobody would see him ruin Morphonius. The judge denied this request, warning him that if he discovered to have recorded the proceedings, he would be arrested. Quest also petitioned the court to strike Morphonius' motion to dismiss. The court also denied. The judge advised Quest that he had 14 days to file a response to Morpheus's motion to dismiss, or Morphonius's motion to dismiss. So would that show up? I mean, is there a way to see like if he actually is trying to follow through with this? And if he doesn't do it in the 14-day window, is that close it? He can never go after him again? Or how does that work?
Yeah, I would think we could look through the Colorado court county. I don't know if they e-file in this court. If they do, it'd be really easy. If not, you'd have to contact the particular courthouse and ask for the documents. So you had 14 days to file a response. That should have been done by now, right?
Yeah, that would be over by this point, I believe.
Yeah.
Or it's very close to it if it's not completely over.
I'm going to guess what the answer is there.
So he wanted to live stream the court. Judge said no. Dismissed it, gave him 14 days, and then at the very end, you can see he links to the documents again, but he says, Steve Quest, your reign of terror is over. No longer will I live in fear of you. But yeah, this guy, what's your take? Well, how would you describe our special little boy here?
Oh, he's a lunatic.
Right?
He's just, you know, the real flaw of our legal system is the fact that it costs a lot whether you have anything to do with the case or not. You know, Morphonius, even if he represented himself pro se, he clearly put time into drafting these documents. And that was a waste. That was a waste that was unnecessary. Just because some moron on the internet had some hate boner for him because of, I don't know, did he What did he even do? Did he ban him, like, from his live chat or something like that? That's what sparks this?
Yeah, from what I understand, he was talking about Sandy Hook and said, hey, could you try to be nice to the parents? Monograph took offense to that. They had a back and forth, and then apparently Jake looked into who he was, and he came across the same stuff I did, right? Which is all this weird sex shit. And he's like, what the fuck is this guy's deal? And then Monograph is like, I'm going to fucking sue you for this. And that's where we are. But again, this all kind of started in April or May, and in June we have a lawsuit. So this guy's saying he's going to come after me. He's going to sue. Yeah, he's saying he's going to sue me. So I'm preparing to be sued again. Remember, pay me. I'm sad. That's how this works.
You're done. You're done, buddy. You're gonna need a lot of money to defend against this suit.
Well, you know, I agree with Rahm Emanuel, who said never let a good crisis go to waste. So let me put this up on screen. First time I've ever done this. Let me DSP this shit. I opened up a Teespring store. So,
oh no!
I know. If you'd like to support me in my future legal battles against Montagraph, buy a hat. Buy Jim's fucking hats. So he doesn't end up living under a bridge or in a fucking TJ Maxx next to Montagraph's fucking, I guess, dressing room? I don't know what you'd describe it as. I'd be living in 148?
Yeah. Well, 148 today, 159 tomorrow. It depends on what section is getting the least amount of traction.
I'm ready for this nutcase. Now, I know when he was talking to Josh, because Josh did a stream with him earlier, he's like, oh, I'm not gonna go after Jim, right? He started to backpedal. I don't buy it. This guy is unhinged. He makes threats against people, and then he does try to follow through with them. I've watched it repeatedly. I've seen him call the cops on people and brag about it. I've seen him attempt to dox people, flag people, do anything you can to get petty revenge. And so when he's saying, I'm going to sue you, I'm prepared. I'm ready. I'm going to show up in labo armor. I'm not scared of you. I'm not scared of you, Monograph. I'm fucking ready for what's coming up with the toe-sucking sweaty squat and my, I guess, egg-headed head of the legal team over here to take you on.
Do you have hats that come in grade A extra large, because that's what I need. Grade A extra large hat for my egg-shaped head.
Oh, well, you know, I actually, because I, like I said, I've never done this before. I looked at who makes hats. And apparently, it's very fucking hard to get them to make a fucking hat. I had to ask really nicely to get them to agree to do it. I was like, "Can you do a hat?" I was like, "I'll do a T-shirt then," because I didn't know if I was going to get an answer. But then I got an answer, so I've got T-shirts and hats. I even got a mug up there. A fucking mug.
The mugs are great. You gotta have the mug.
I need to raise the price to $50. So thank you, Monograph, for making me hat rich. Your legal threats really are spooky. I'm so scared over here. He rubs me the wrong way, I guess, Nick, if I had to put it into simple terms. I just don't like him. Like, I see him, he threatens people all the time with his petty shit. It's like, if you want to make fun of people and fuck with people, fine, but don't start threatening to sue everybody and get them flagged down and dox them, because you can't take the same shit being thrown back at you.
Of course. Yeah, he's your typical keyboard warrior. It's actually pathetic how mundane he is, right? Like, it's not creative. It's not funny. There's no artistic flair added to it. He's indistinguishable from any other number of people who would... I'm going to dox you. I'm going to find your employer and get you fired. And if that doesn't work, I'm going to call big bad government down to put you through the courts. I mean, what is this guy like Zoe Quinn or whatever? It's the same boring playbook. Just be funnier. What's wrong with these people?
Well, yeah, and he's been doing it for a decade. I mean, I looked into a lot of the stuff and trying to find as much as I could. And I ran into multiple accounts, and like, it's not just, you know, shit posters. Like, he'll just target like fucking old women on Facebook and shit. Like, one woman's like, yeah, he tried to, you know, ruin my life. Another guy's like, he went after my 70-year-old father. Another guy's like, he got me fired. Like, it's just all these people. He's been doing this shit for year after year after year. And now he's moved into the frivolous lawsuit bullshit. So, you know, I guess I'm ready. I thought it would be something else. I thought it would be a furry or a juggalo or some other weird fucking group on the internet, but whatever. If I got to deal with a Q-boomer, I got to deal with a Q-boomer.
Yeah, I mean, but you're calling down the entire weight of the CIA on you.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, we're talking super deep state shit here. Yeah,
and I've seen the belt lines of CIA agents, too. That's a lot of weight coming down, Jim.
Oh, I know it. Yeah, I mean, not only has he worked for the CIA, but he single-handedly destroyed it, too.
Oh, God. What a disaster of a person. Is that, so I guess here's the question for you. What's the next step after his lawsuits don't work on people, right? Because he's escalating.
Yeah.
So is he going to have, like, a breakup note, and we're going to see him on a – what was it, Jake? What was who found the person swinging in the forest in there in Japan?
Oh, yeah, the suicide forest one. Oh, fuck, I don't remember. Logan Paul or Jake Paul, one of the Pauls. Paul something.
Yeah, that guy's gonna finally get admitted back to Japan, go back to the same forest, and find that guy swinging from a tree in Minecraft with a sign that says "Gotcha, Metokur."
Well, yeah, I mean, I could speculate on what he's gonna do, but. You know, when the flagging and the doxing and the swatting doesn't work, and then the lawsuits don't work, who knows what this guy's going to get up to? But just the fact that he called you on the phone from one tweet, and the fact that he filed a lawsuit against Jake Morfonius after he basically banned him from chat saying, stop being a shithead, you know, speaks volumes as to what this guy is just, he comes off as just a real tryhard, I guess.
Now, he claims... in his lawsuit that Morfonius, you know, actually accused me of vile and disgusting acts during a live broadcast. Do we have any evidence that Morfonius actually said anything about him other than just banning him from the channel?
I think he did a follow-up stream after that where he looked into him and he came across all the sex cult shit and
he came across
all the Tutu Sue stuff. And he's like, yeah, this is disgusting. And I think that's what he's referring to. But again, I mean, it's a guy that's commenting on material that's already out there. He's not producing it. I think that's why that exhibit showed that when he did the search, it was an already established term.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. There's another document, and I don't know which one I clicked on, but it says, defendant, in fact...
Oh, hold on. Let me pull it up here 1 second. Okay.
Okay. I'm trying to think.
Do you know which page it's on?
Oh, this is Quest Response to Morfonius Motion.
Okay, here we go. I see where you are.
Yeah, and it's right up at the top. So this is response to motion. This is not a proper response to the motion at all.
Okay.
But he says, the defendant, in fact, falsely accused the plaintiff of pedophilia a number of times during the defendant's live broadcast on April 6th, as proven in Exhibit Number 1 DVD.
He sent the court a DVD, did he?
Apparently. I'm requesting that the defendant issue a full on-camera video. His Blackstone Intelligence Network YouTube page, a full retraction for defaming and falsely accusing the plaintiff of pedophilia and a monetary judgment. Well, the first part, the court can't compel people to speak, so that's probably not going to happen. You'd have to get that in settlement.
That quartering went to court with the dude in the dress that smacked him. And I think the end result of that was the guy went on camera and apologized. So I'm guessing that was something agreed upon by the lawyers, not issued by the court.
Yeah, that was settled outside. Typically, the court is not going to use the power of the state to force someone to speak. It kind of goes against the First Amendment. So they don't usually do that. In some criminal cases, they'll ask for an apology, but I think they usually ask for it and it's part of the sentencing.
Here's the exhibit. In Exhibit 1 DVD, defendant, with his face and voice, accuses the plaintiff of being a pedophile. The live stream broadcast occurred on April 6, 2019. From the defendant's Blackstone Intelligence Network YouTube channel. The defendant falsely accused the plaintiff of pedophilia a number of times during that live stream. Over 4,500 people heard and saw the video, which triggered this very lawsuit. So this is his follow-up, I guess, because the first one made no sense. And he's trying to... this is more specific? Is that specific enough?
No. I mean... It's not going to be specific enough to overcome the jurisdiction problems. Because he would have to prove that he had directed the acts towards Colorado. If he really wanted to sue him, he would have to sue him in federal court or in state court in North Carolina or wherever the defendant actually is, where they'd have jurisdiction over him. That's the biggest hurdle he's got. What page were you reading that on? Six, you said?
Oh, yeah. So or... it's the 11-page document, the response. It's yeah. the second page, plaintiff's answer. It says Exhibit 1 DVD.
Oh. Gotcha.
Yeah, it's from the paragraph where it says, see quest response to morphonious motion. And then the second page of that. It's just that one little oh, paragraph.
Yeah. There we go. Yeah. No. And it wasn't... this he's addressing other parts of the motion, but I got dismissed on jurisdictional grounds, so they didn't even get to this other stuff. Yeah, he would have had to amend his pleadings rather than just answering in the motion. He could have requested that to the court. But I mean, this is why you get a lawyer, right? The interesting thing is, he raises kind of a good argument on page 3 of the answer that we're reading here.
Okay.
And this, if he had fleshed this out, he might have. It's right at the beginning. It says defendant and defendants Blackstone Intelligence Network YouTube channel has over 200,000 subscribers. And on April 6, 2019, defendant conducted a live stream and accused the plaintiff of pedophilia a number of times while over 600 people were watching live. Over 4,500 people saw the video. Oh, wait, is it not there? Damn it. I got mixed up on which one it is. But there's one where it talks about he is a journalist with a standard of journalistic integrity. This is actually part of a defamation cause of action. Where okay. is it? Where you argue that basically they...
Oh, is it the third paragraph? The defendant's introduction to this very lawsuit explicitly points out what a professional independent journalist the defendant is,
coupled
with his investigational skills.
Yep. So what one way you establish the failure of a journalist to because they get some special protections for defamation. But one way you get past that is by saying that they failed to exercise the ordinary care that they would or the standard of care that they've established themselves to use as a journalist. So if this guy claims to be a journalist.
Oh, wait a second. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I've got the stupid merchandise thing over the page.
Oh,
oh no, that's everything's going to shit.
Oh no.
There we go. Sorry. There we go. All right, that was my fuck up. I'm sorry. I look over it and double check and I was like, oh wait, nobody can read the fucking legal document because
look, chat, if up. You want the overlay to move, you just gotta buy the hat.
You need to buy the hat. Yeah, buy a couple fucking mugs if you want that to disappear.
Everybody who bought a hat, mug, and t-shirt combo, the overlay was actually gone. So
yeah,
that was your bad.
I will say this in the second paragraph. He harped on this a lot, too, with my first live stream. A defendant was making money via AdSense donations and super chats for the defendant's defamation against the plaintiff.
That burns him up, doesn't it?
It does. He counted how many super chats I got on the first stream. Like, he sat out and counted them all and then kept repeating the total out as he talked. He was fuming about it, yeah. So I think this one pissed him off, too.
Yeah, that's... That's the thing that pisses all these people off, right? It's not only that you do it, but it's that you make money at it. Oh God, it burns people up. God,
just to state this again, I wouldn't be doing like I'm moving over to DLive to do streaming in the morning and stuff, kind of like I did on StreamMe.
Yeah,
and that was my plan. And then this guy starts going off on me. So, the reason I'm even fucking streaming over here on YouTube still. Is because he initially said, I don't have the video on hand, but it was one more of his, you know, you're going to learn you a lesson shit. He's like, you're too scared to stream on YouTube. You know what will happen if you do it.
Oh, so, you know what's going to happen. You know what's coming.
Yeah, you know what's coming. Lawsuits and flagging. So I was like, fuck this guy. So I streamed on YouTube. And if I do any more streams about this, if this gets crazier, if he files his fucking court case and all that other bullshit, all coming here. I'm going to fucking do it here. You can burn the channel down. I don't give a shit. I don't know. I just don't like if you make fun of me, if you laugh at me, is really what it boils down to. If you laugh at me, I'm going to teach you a lesson kind of shit. It's so stupid.
Yeah, let me give Montagraph a little lesson. Laughing at someone on the internet is like standing across a highway and pointing at someone and laughing. And it is not illegal to stand across a highway and point at someone and laugh. It is not illegal if 7 billion people on the earth are standing on one side of the highway, pointing their finger at you and laughing, and you're the only guy. And that's probably what's happening here. Not 7 billion, but anybody who sees this is laughing at you, Montagraph. No one's laughing with you.
Right. Well, I you know, I think a good way maybe to kind of we're kind of getting to the end of the Montagraph stuff. Should we show people his hot memes, the stuff that he just completely fucked you out of the park with?
Yeah. Can you give me like 2 minutes and I'll be right back. I got to run and do something real quick.
Oh, is he knocking at your door already? All right. Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, I'll be right back. But if you want to start getting into it, I'll pop back on in just a second.
Yep. Not a problem. All right, Chad, give me a second here. Let me pull this shit up. These would be the hot memes that Montagraph made to teach old Nick here a fucking lesson. I think you're going to enjoy them. They're pretty fucking devastating. So let me pull these up here. God, he made like 100 of them. So fucking many of these stupid ass things. Okay, here we go. Starting from 16 hours ago. Let's just do window. Oh, no, I'll do desktop capture. There we go. That'll work. So here they are from Montagraph, and this is for some reason directed at me and Nick. It's nice to know that certain attorneys will do anything for new clients. Isn't that right, Nicky? Defeat is your business, huh? Laugh my ass off. It is now. And you could see the devastating meme. Head counsel of the Sweaty Sausage Squad, Nick sucking on toes with two forkfuls of fucking sausages. Anti-bully right there, and I guess that's Rekieta Law's logo. Knocked them right out of the ballpark on that one. Another one. There's nothing better than an attorney that gives great service. Thanks, Nikki. You are going to make a lot of sausages standing up. Take notice. That's what I call attorney-client privilege. And he's put him in a gimp mask. Is he at the United Nations? We'll never know. He's got his leather bondage gear on. Another devastating picture. Here's one of him drinking potato head alcohol. You're going to like that. Here's one of him taking a shit. 24/7 counsel of the Sweaty Sausage Squad. Always a good one. Oh, here's one. Before I was the head of counsel for the Sweaty Sausage Squad, I worked at Wells Fargo. They didn't take me seriously there either. And there's a little egg-shaped Nick Rekieta. And he's driving a tricycle on his way to something busy and important. It feels good to be accepted by a bunch of sweaty sausages. When it comes to being an actual pro attorney, I can't compete. Poor Nikki. Just added them right in there. Oh, here's another one. A troll attorney. Head counsel for the Sweaty Sausage Squad. He really likes that sweaty sausage shit.
Oh, I love the sweaty sausage.
Oh, yeah, we're just going through them. Here's the bear one. Being the head counsel of the Sweaty Sausage Squad, some days I need hugs. Attorneys' feelings matter. He's just, how do you fucking respond to this?
I've got to respond to this. This meme is accurate. I worked at Wells Fargo, and they didn't take me seriously there either. That is true. That is true. I told them not to when I got hired. I said, I'm the worst salesman ever. Don't hire me for a sales job. And then they did. It was great. Good job.
Now, did you actually work at Wells Fargo?
Oh, yeah. For a year in downtown St. Paul. It was the worst year of my entire life.
How did he know that?
I've said it before on a stream.
Well, yeah, but he's not going to know that you said it on a stream. He responded immediately to you.
I don't know. Maybe there's maybe he did one of those background check websites or whatever that has previous employers or something.
Well, I mean, maybe this clears it up. He's got Illuminati written on the bottom of his memes. So
that's true.
I think, you know, talking about rent-a-daddies, he you know, showed us your real teeth. Embarrassing. Free cases for kisses, apparently.
Well, that's true. Yeah. it's not pro bono. It's pro boner, right? You got to get those. You got to get the smoochies in to get a little roused up. That's why we do the cases for free.
Well, yeah. And then he's got one of his final memes. His super hot banter is you as an egghead under a billboard of Agent 19 coming to get you. I guess let me ask you in all seriousness, if he files a complaint, you're going to read that on stream? You're going to have some fun with that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Please. Oh, man. The worst thing I can do is have complaints come in. God, it's terrible. I hate when people call me out for my professional ethics and all of that stuff. if this dummy is stupid enough to like sue or file an ethics complaint or whatever, I mean, what do we have to hide here? We got to just go ahead and tell the world about legal process.
Well, when he drops his lawsuit against me and of course seven sweaty men, Google, and 900 other people that he's threatened to sue over the last week, you're going to have me on stream so we can read through that complaint once he files it.
God, I hope so.
Because I'm really looking forward. I'm really fucking looking forward to what he's going to end up coming up with.
I hope this low rent, low effort idiot puts more than four lines into you. Four handwritten lines on a self-help document. I mean, can we at least get a paragraph? I don't want a 3-minute stream, right?
Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, I was thinking back to, like, okay, what is he going to come after me for? I honestly can't think of anything. Like, I'm not Jake Morfonius. I didn't accuse him of pedophilia. All I've accused him of, again, are verifiable things he has himself said he does.
Yeah. It's a weird one, but you know, he knows a lot though. Maybe he's going to have to learn you on what you did.
Well, he's going to learn me real good. And then he's going to memes the shit out of me. And we're both going to be, just crying in a corner trying to deal with this. I'm sorry that you, I guess, got dragged into this, for tweeting about it. And anybody listening, don't, whatever you do, don't tweet about this, because this guy will put you on the shit list and you're going to get sued along with all of us in Google. Just know that it's coming.
Take it from me. Nothing is more stressful and trying than the results of the tweet.
Oh, I know. God. It's damaging beyond fucking measure. Well, I appreciate you coming out to join me on this. I just wanted your, I guess, legal take on it. And then, you know, I was going to have you do just that initially, but then he releases a video, just outright saying he's coming. Like, he releases it saying he's coming for you, for no fucking reason. Yeah, it's the very last one. Counsel for the Sweaty Sausage Squad equals too funny. But he's deleted it. But at least I was able to save it so we could watch some of that, and I wanted to get your takes on that. Do you have any, you know, upcoming Vic streams? Like, what do you have coming up soon?
Well, as soon as I get some more information on the depositions, or maybe some transcripts or transcripts of the hearings that happened during the depositions, we'll be covering those. As for the specifics of this coming week, Ty Beard, of course, is Vic's lawyer. I believe I'm going to have his daughters on at some point this week. They both work for his law firm and in various roles. Neither are lawyers, but they do different things for the firm. So we'll have them on to talk and get to know them a little bit. Other than that, until we get some, I think there's going to be some shenanigans. I think the anti-slap is coming up in the Vic case, which should be fun, to talk about. And the anti-slap is great, because everybody is talking about, oh, this case is going to lose on anti-slap, or this is anti-slap. Nobody will fucking file it. Just file the anti-slap. Please, dear God, file the anti-slap so we can move past it. That would be wonderful.
You keep waiting for it, but they're not going to do it, are they?
I kind of wonder if they aren't. I think they were waiting to have Vic get deposed, and they thought he was going to just like cry like a baby, and they were going to slag him and then file the anti-slap after that. That got headed off early. And then what happened in Vic's deposition is that they maybe forgot that they were deposing an actor who sits and talks to hundreds and hundreds of people from all walks of life for like 9 to 10 hours straight at a time for 3 days a row every weekend, and that he might not be too broken up by a 6-hour deposition. Like, he might be able to just deal with that.
Oh yeah. They tried that against Alex Jones. I remember that they, you know, it was specifically mentioned a few times, oh, it's going to be a 6-hour deposition, but Jones was like, whatever.
Yeah. Jones sits there and anybody who sits in broadcasts for 3, 4, 5 hours a night, a day or whatever, is probably going to get through a deposition just fine, unless they've got something that nails you to the wall that you don't know that they have. But typically, you know exactly what they have because you gave it to them.
Yeah.
So,
well, can I ask you this? I guess I probably should have asked it earlier. He files his lawsuit, right?
Yeah.
So what does it cost me to fly down, I guess, in Colorado or North Carolina, wherever the fuck he files it? Let's say I decide to go.
Sure.
What's a court case cost when you're going to do this?
You're going to have, I mean, you're likely just going to have filing fees for it. If you're doing it yourself, right, you're going to have filing fees for it. You can probably electronically file or file by mail. You wouldn't have to do it in person.
Okay.
Especially if you're contesting jurisdiction, which I'm guessing you would if he filed it in Colorado, unless you're in Colorado, which I don't think is the case. But, if you're, If you're not in Colorado and he files there, you contest jurisdiction. You can probably do it and request leave of the court to appear by like a phone call or something, since there's no reason for you to have to undergo the burden of flying into Colorado. So you're really looking at a filing fee, and you can maybe even get it waived and force him to pay it. Based on the ludicrousness of it, or he might have to pay you back, but it'd probably be a motion maybe to dismiss, maybe $100-$150.
Oh, that's okay. Well, let me ask you this. If I show up to court in a labo armor with just underwear and glasses on, how's the judge going to look at that?
Depends on the judge. Sorry.
Does it depend on the judge?
I think they would not be too happy with it. They would probably ask you to leave and come back in at least street clothes.
Okay. All right. So you're saying lab armor might not be the best approach for the first day?
Now, maybe what you could do is get on the People's Court or Judge Joe Brown or whatever, and then you can show up however you want.
Oh. Oh, God. Too bad Wapner's not in the fucking thing anymore. I miss that. I got Judge Wapner in some lab armor would be a nice combination.
Yeah, he would love it. He'd love it.
All right. Well, thank you for coming out and discussing it. I know this is silliness. This guy is something else, but I wanted some hot legal takes. And just your live responses to his threats to basically release a phone call and make you a website.
That's really polite of him. I'm the worst, the boomerest of web developers. And so I don't have a proper website. So if he does one for me, that'd be great. And if he releases that phone call, I guess everyone will just have to see how I talk to people who are just trying to defend themselves.
Yeah, I thought it was really weird. Yeah, he kept harping on it like it was some big revelation. And I was like, well, I bet, you know, he got the phone call and he's like, who the fuck are you?
Yeah, but that's the long and short of it. And then I talked to him. I'm stupid. I'll talk to people, I guess. When I'm just driving around, cause I didn't have anything else to do. But it was kind of interesting. So if he releases it, I'm definitely devastated. And, I'm sure all of my peers who, don't already hate the fact that I go online and talk about the law while drinking whiskey will be really depressed at how I handled a phone call with a weirdo on the internet.
Oh yeah. It's career ruining. Really. I mean, it's the end of a legacy that you've built up, but it had to happen sometime.
It did. It's all going down. Crash and burn.
All right. Well, thank you so much for popping on. Anybody that's interested in following up on the Vic stuff, it's Nick Rekieta, Rekieta Law on YouTube. I'll put a link up in the description.
Hey, thanks, buddy.
On the re-upload, because I usually pull these down afterwards. But good luck. Pray for me. I'm going to need it. I'll pray for you. Our prayers together, hopefully, will get us through this trying time.
Yeah. We're going to need all the prayer we can get.
Okay. All right. Take it easy, man.
Yeah, man. You too. Peace.
All right. Bye. All right. Well, that was Nick Rekieta. Give me the hot legal expertise on dealing with a Q-LARPer on the internet who's just running around threatening to sue everybody. Again, I'm now on that list, along with Drummer, PayPal, Google, Twitter, seven Sweaty Men, Liquid Monty. Nick's on that list as well. I'm sure Josh will be on that list for daring to talk to him earlier. He'll get annoyed about that eventually and decide he's going to sue him. Everybody's getting sued. So we'll see how that turns out. Give me a moment to go grab a drink. I know I had super chats and stuff come through. I will read through those all and answer them. And then we'll close it up. Everybody can go have a nice weekend and I can start preparing to be homeless, because apparently I'm just going to be struck with poverty when this psychopath decides that he's going to drag me into court for hurting his feelings because I laughed at him. Of course, why wouldn't he do that? Put this up. Is that not going to scroll now? Oh, there we go. Oh, actually, you know what? I wanted to... Let me show this before I grab a drink. This was... I'll just put it up. Here we go.
Now, our bully hunter has asked the Rose Thorn live in-game who is harassing her. And our victim then immediately replied. Let's zoom in again on the bottom left-hand corner. Now, you see there, the tool connected these two. A victim with a bully hunter.
You're not an anti-bully. You are the bully.
I'm a meanie. I'm a big goddamn meanie. All right. Let me go grab a drink here. And then I'll read through the super chats. Put a little music on in the background. Put a little music on while I go to do this. What should we listen? I know what we'll listen to. One moment. So if you got to take a piss, grab a drink, do what you got to do. We will be back in like 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 2 minutes to 5 minutes. I'm not sure how long it will take. And then we'll read through all this stuff. But if you're taking off right now, thanks for coming out. Hope you enjoyed the stream. Have a good weekend. Jump into the Super Chats in just a minute here, and I will be right back.
Cause you got that.